And welcome back here on Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Time for the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We appreciate you all being here. Tom Callahan here with you. First of a pair between these two teams here tonight and tomorrow night. Blue Ridge Bobcats in town to take on Columbus, and looking forward to having the Bobcats back in town, and you hope the River Dragons once again able to take care of business as they did here in this building on Teddy Bear Toss Night, December 16th. It was a 4-0 win back then. Well, I told you before the break, there are a couple of River Dragons chasing history coming into this weekend's set, and we had a couple of guys who hit some of those milestones here in this last week's set against Carolina. So in case you didn't hear, Josh Petrantonio played his 300th professional game and notched his 200th pro assist in the same game. That was New Year's Eve against Carolina. Now, he still needs 4 assists for 200 in the FPHL. Might get those this weekend. Petro's been on a bit of a tear lately. Comes in on a 4-game point scoring streak. Not quite as impressive as the 10-gamer Justin McDonald comes in on. And McDonald, probably the biggest one as far as that chase for history goes. He is sitting on 596 career points coming into tonight's game and 299 FPHL points. So 4 points for 600 in his pro career and just 1 point for 300 in his FPHL career. Now, the interesting thing about that is, as I told you, he's on a 10-game point scoring streak right now. And out of every single game Columbus has played this year, J-Mac has only been held off the score sheet twice the entire season. And the last time he didn't have a point was November 25th against Carolina. So he's definitely been delivering. And right now you look at a guy like McDonald and you can only hope that he keeps it going here tonight. And again, we have some history to talk about. That would actually be an awful lot of fun if we had a little bit of that here for the River Dragons here this evening. Certainly reason to have hope looking at him. And again, Petrantonio on a 4-gamer, Austin Doe on a 4-gamer. I do have to let you know, River Dragons fans, that Kyle Moore, a 1-game suspension for an obscene gesture. He will not be in the lineup here tonight, so Moore is out. And that means instead of having to choose between Sequoia Swan and Carson Andreoli, both will be in the lineup here this evening for the Columbus River Dragons. It also means for the River Dragons that they're going to have a look at, well, I guess more of what the rookies can do. We've seen them, and I'm going to throw Ryan Hunter in here as well, see them go in fits and starts. But just talking a little bit about what's happening with this hockey team with Carson Andreoli. Of course, he missed some time and hasn't quite been the same since coming off of IR. But trying to get him going, trying to get Sequoia Swan going, and Ryan Hunter had a stretch there where, boy, you thought to yourself, he had a 4-game point streak that he put together, had 5 goals in those 4 games, and that was just in the middle of December. But since then, in his last 3, just 1 assist. He's been quiet a little bit again. And for rookies, it can be tough. You're playing your first full season of pro. You're trying to find kind of that flow to your game and to your team. And so you're going to have some up nights, some down nights. But I think every time we chat with head coach Jerome Bichard, he kind of puts it in the context of trying to reduce the focus point, make it simpler. Tell these kids and even some of the veteran players sometimes, hey, just simplify it. Make the play you're supposed to make. They practice on it all week. They drill on it all week. If you get the puck here, try to move it here. That is your first and best option. If for whatever reason that's not open, okay, now we got to figure it out from there. But that is a lot of what the talk is with this River Dragons team, is to try to figure out exactly where they need to move the puck, how they need to move the puck, and if they're going to be able to do so in a way that is conducive to getting those guys going, because the turnovers have really been what has killed the River Dragons. When they've done it to themselves. They're turning the puck over, whether it's in the offensive zone, in the neutral zone, it can be on a zone entry. Instead of putting the puck in, going to get it, trying to maintain some zone time, set a cycle, it's maybe a 50-50 pass across the middle or a stretch pass. If it lands, it can give your team a tremendous advantage. If you miss, it kind of flips things the other way. And now all of a sudden you find yourself a little bit behind the eight ball. And I think that is what one of the biggest probably bones of contention, if I may, for Jerome Bichard with this team is, if you cut those out, those mistakes that are really the tennis equivalent of unforced errors, it gets better, a lot quicker, because now you're playing with the puck more. Now the other team has to chase you a little bit more. Now they might have to take risks or do things they don't normally do. Well, that's exactly what you want. And that's what Columbus would want, is to make teams take those risks, open it up a little bit. We saw that happen against Mississippi earlier this season. The Seawolves were trading chances with the River Dragons, and it was a close game, but then all of a sudden, Columbus got a couple to start the third period. It was a different look and a different feel in that game from then on, because all of a sudden, now the Seawolves felt the pressure, and they had to open it up even beyond what they were comfortable with. When that happens, and you're forcing other teams to take chances, that's when you find ways to score goals. That's when you find those mistakes. And it gets a little more frantic, and that turns a 3-2 game into a 5-2 game real fast. So for Columbus, that is an absolutely huge thing to circle on the to-do list for this game here against the Blue Ridge Bobcats. So tonight and tomorrow night, Blue Ridge in town. Don't forget, tomorrow night is the debut of the blackout jerseys for 2024. So you'll definitely want to come down and be a part of that if you can. We'd love to have you here. I know I mentioned Tim Hortons a little bit earlier on, trying to get back on that Tim Hortons win streak. Any win streak of three or more games this year, presented by Tim Hortons throughout January, earn free Tim's faster by scoring 2x points on all orders. Plus, stop on Mondays for a free coffee with purchase. That's Mondays, free coffee with purchase, all through the Tim's app. Pre-game show is brought to you by Air Force Heating and Air, the official heating and air company of the Columbus River Dragons. And we just found this out today, so I want to share this with you. The next Eat with the River Dragons event at Chick-fil-A Midland will be January 25th from 6 to 7 p.m. So mark your calendars now. Again, January 25th from 6 to 7 p.m. You can come eat with the team, get autographs, pictures, and more. And that's only at Chick-fil-A Midland. We'll take a break here in the pregame show. When we come back, we'll take a look at our Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard. And if you didn't see what happened in the World Juniors today, we'll fill you in on that. The bronze medal and gold medal matchup. USA taking on Sweden for the gold. We'll fill you in on that, as well as what's going on around the FPHL, the NHL, and more. Stay tuned. Plenty more coming your way. This is the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call...
Winter is upon us. We must prepare.
It's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Air Force Heating and Air, the official AC sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, is excited to offer you our special $79 tune-up. Call us today at 706-661-7242 or visit us at airforceheatingandair.com. That's Air Force Heating
Air. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Introducing New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. Music to my ears.
You don't have ears.
Starry, it's different.
Good internet. For a limited time, get super fast internet and YouTube TV starting at just $82.98 per month.
Wow.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app,
as we get to our Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard, the FPHL, as it always is on a night that is either labeled Friday or Saturday, packed across the league. We have all but one team in action here tonight. And it looks like, I believe it's the Zydeco. Nope, the Zydeco are actually playing tonight. Let's figure this out here. Binghamton is off tonight. So right now, First Arena in Elmira. You have Danbury and the River Sharks. They are scoreless about halfway through that first period of play as they got underway just a little bit earlier. And then a Watertown Arena, Motor City and Watertown. They're getting set to drop the puck in just a little bit here. Have not gotten underway just yet. At 7:35, the Port Huron Prowlers are at the Carolina Thunderbirds tonight. And then 7:05 Central, 8:05 Eastern. The Baton Rouge Zydeco are at the Mississippi Seawolves. And the NHL, a very light night on a Friday here tonight. And three games to tell you about, two of which are already underway. The Devils and the Blackhawks are about 6.5 minutes into period number one. That game is scoreless. Capitals with an early goal from Dowd lead the Hurricanes 1-0. And that one just not quite 7 minutes into the first period. Then the only other game tonight, 10 o'clock Eastern, you've got the Jets at the Ducks. Men's college basketball at the half. Number four, UConn trails Butler 42-35. And then later on tonight, number one, Purdue is at number nine, Illinois at 8:30 p.m. Eastern. In the National Football League, week 18 means an awful lot to an awful lot of teams. It starts tomorrow at 4:30. Steelers at the Ravens. And then at 8:15, Texans at Colts. Sunday at 1 o'clock, you've got Browns at Bengals, Vikings at Lions, Jags at Titans, Jets at the Patriots, Falcons at Saints, Buccaneers at the Panthers, Bears at the Packers. And that's actually a 4:30 game. Bears at Packers, Broncos at Raiders, Eagles at Giants, Seahawks at Cardinals, Chiefs at Chargers, Rams at 49ers, and Cowboys at Commanders, all in the late window. The Sunday night game, which is this year, there's no Monday night game to end the season. This is the last game of the regular season, will be the Bills at the Dolphins for that AFC East Championship. And then the World Junior Championships. Hockey fans, I know you're interested to know what happened, so let's talk about it. In the bronze medal game, an incredible comeback as Finland blows a lead against Czechia by allowing them to score four goals, the fastest four goals in World Juniors history. And they come from down 5-3 to up 6-5 and then end up winning 8-5 is your final. So Czechia with what some consider an upset. Others who've been watching the tournament aren't so ready to call it an upset. But boy, oh boy, 8-5, what a win for Czechia over Finland in the bronze medal game. Just an incredible stretch. Huge comeback. And then in the gold medal game here today, the United States 6-2 over Sweden. After winning Group B with 11 points, the United States, the pre-tournament favorite, comes in and against the host nation Sweden, takes care of business. It was a 3-2 game heading into the third before the United States finally was able to blow that one open. So that is a look at the Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard. And as we turn the page back to this game, it is the River Dragons taking on the Blue Ridge Bobcats. And that's coming up here in just a little bit. And we appreciate you being with us here tonight. Thank you so much for joining us, because right now with this Columbus River Dragons hockey team, I know there's just a lot of things when you take a look at, hey, what's going on in and around the FPHL. It's so close to the top of this division. Every game matters. And when you're supposed to put a team away, and for Columbus, in their minds, and this is not a bad thing to say, it's every team. They should be putting every team away. You have to take care of the teams below you in the standings. You don't want them to get going, and you certainly don't want to give away points. The other thing that's important are the regulation wins. To win in regulation means 3 points, not two. And when you have Carolina taking out third place Port Huron tonight. Port Huron, 5-4-1 in their last 10. They've won their last two. Are the Prowlers finally putting it together? I've been talking on the FPHL podcast about maybe even them being a little disappointing to me so far this year. But maybe they're putting it together a little bit here. Mississippi is another team that has to really figure things out. But I think that the Port Huron Prowlers are in a position where they can begin to separate themselves from the lower part of the Continental Division as well. Binghamton, with the night off in the Empire, they've got 55 points. They're sitting pretty. They're 14 points free and clear of Motor City at 41. But Danbury is another team that I look at and say, okay, what are these guys going to be? Where are they going to go? And they're facing an Elmira team tonight, 4-6 in its last 10, which is saying something when they're 5-13. So it's good to see the River Sharks maybe putting it together a little bit. And Stick Tap, the former River Dragon and now current River Shark, Stephen Klink, who's named the Rookie of the Month for the FPHL. In fact, if you missed it, the FPHL came out with its awards earlier. And Klink named Rookie of the Month for the FPHL. Mario Cavalieri was named the Goaltender of the Month for December. And Gus Ford was named the Player of the Month for December. So Carolina with a couple of honors in their pocket there as well. All right, time for us to take one more break in this Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. And when we come back, we're going to chat with head coach Jerome Bichard. Stay tuned. There's more coming your way in just a moment on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app, energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Watch out, watch out.
Ew.
She said yes.
Yeah.
So fast, so reliable, so much to love. For a limited time, get internet 1 gig for just $50 a month.
Peppermint season is back at Tim Hortons, with even more peppermint flavor. It's the tastiest, mintiest way to cheers the holidays. Tis the season to treat yourself with any $1 medium latte when you order on the app. Only at Tim Hortons.
I'm thirsty.
Try this.
Starry.
It's a new lemon lime soda that's crisp, clear, and
so refreshing. So tasty.
What the?
Just let it happen. No!
Oh, true. He was a soda.
New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. It's different.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
I'm always on.
Welcome back here in the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We're joined by head coach Jerome Bichard. Coach, thanks for joining us. And as we flip the calendar page to 2024, I know we talked about it on the coaches show this week just a little bit, but do you have any resolutions hockey-wise for your team here?
Hockey-wise? Less turnovers, more quality shots on net. How about that?
Okay, those sound like a couple of good resolutions. Now, how do you go about putting those into action here in 2024?
You know what? Just, again, always putting in the back of their minds, putting in the guys, talking about it all the time, guys. I'm like, listen, it's a 3-on-2. I don't want a 50-50 turnover at the top of the circles because you guys are trying something. I want a shot and hit the net. I'd rather have that and, you know, that way we can get ourselves into a cycle or get into that puck possession that we want to play. But, you know, those 50-50 slide passes or lazy little things, and if it works, it's great. If not, it's coming back the other way. You know, we want to eliminate that.
I know even in the NHL last couple of years, there's been a trend. They call it the pass off the pad. You shoot it low to the far side of the goalie and let him kick it back out like it's a pass.
Shot with a purpose. We do a lot of it in practice. I haven't seen us get rewarded for it in a game because more than likely, most of my guys are trying to shoot to score all up in this little area right here, about this big. And that's where they shoot. I'm like, guys, put it down here, and if you hit it, you're going to score. If you don't, it's going to be a rebound, and you know that's stuff we've been I talk religiously about.
Talk about Blue Ridge, if you will, coming in here. We've only seen these guys once at home and three times this year, and a team that is, you know, kind of in a makeover mode here, a little bit different look.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, the Bobcats. I think they work hard. They got a good coach. They play fairly disciplined. I think they're probably near the bottom as far as penalty minutes, I think. I don't know. I'd have to look that one up, Tom. I would say us and them are probably near the bottom, I would imagine.
We definitely are, yes.
And you know what? And that's not not really by design. It's we want to play disciplined, and when it's time to throw down and go get it, let's do that and or whatever. So I want to think we need to be disciplined, like in our routes and in taking penalties. Our power play and our penalty kill have to be strong. And, you know, I think our 5-on-5, we should be able to take care of them.
Well, that sounds like a pretty good lead in to the keys to the game for tonight.
Keys to the game, again, eliminate turnovers. We want to be physical. And when I say physical, we don't have to bone-crushing hits. But if I skate 5 feet towards you, I might as well bump into you as opposed to turning and going somewhere else type thing. So being physical, that win our battles on the wall, and we should be all right.
All right, Boomer, thanks for joining us. Best of luck tonight.
You bet. Thank you.
Back with the drop of the puck in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability, so for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services, because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me.
There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win.
Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Thank you.
anthem in the books. We are ready to go before tonight's game here. Between the River Dragons and the Blue Ridge Bobcats, Tom Callahan welcoming you in. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's take a look right now at tonight's starting goaltenders. For the River Dragons here this evening, it's going to be Brendan Colgan getting the nod in net. He's 7-2-0-1 with a 2.89 goals against average, .895 save percentage, and one shutout. Meanwhile, it's Owen Liskowitz, 1-2-0-1 for the Bobcats, .893 and a 5.30. Comes over in that trade from Watertown. And we'll see what he can do in a Blue Ridge uniform here this evening. And so River Dragons wearing red, as they always do on Fridays. Red stands for Remember Everyone Deployed. And the River Dragons encourage you, if you're coming out to a River Dragons game on a Friday, to wear your red as well. In just a moment, we'll get to our referee introductions, which are sponsored by The Optical Shop. You should see the game they're missing right now at The Optical Shop in Phoenix City. Just $99 in a bag of chips gets you two pair of eyeglasses. Tonight's referees are Brian Cole and Phil Roessler, and the linesmen Todd Greenberg and Richard Langtree. So the River Dragons rolling left to right on your radio dial or on your YouTube broadcast here, and it will indeed be Justin McDonald starting it out at center as he's chirping across the way at Alex Basie, the former River Dragon wearing number 93 for this Blue Ridge team, just activated today after being acquired in a trade last week. Plenty of moves for the Bobcats. We talked about it in the pregame show. They're going to move into the attack quickly. There's a shot Colgan to save as McDonald paddles a rebound away to the point, not out. Another chance in the slot, and on goal, Colgan, another save, and he reaches out to haul that rebound in and hold on. Just 25 seconds into period number one, the Blue Ridge Bobcats come out applying the pressure. This first period is brought to you by Chick-fil-A Midland. Our next Eat with the River Dragons event at Chick-fil-A Midland will be on January 25th from 6 to 7 p.m. Mark that on your calendars now. We look forward to seeing you out there at that one. Columbus with a draw to the left of its own net. Bersani in there, and he's able to move it over to Doe. Petrantonio out there as well, completing this forward unit. Petrantonio on the right side had it pressured, knocked off his sticks. Lahetka back into his own end after the puck. He'll feed it on the near side. Popoff wheels it back to Slahetka on the far wing, up the left side. Pass out to center, pass Doe. Bersani ties his man up. There'll be no icing here. Back into the Bobcats' end. Up the left side, Nicoletti trying to wheel through center for Blue Ridge. He'll dump it in from there. Colgan slowing it down behind the net. Ryan Gill lost it, side of the goal. Here's a chance in the slot, but well, two Bobcats collide there. Frazee couldn't get a shot away. Ends up on the near wing with Petrantonio. Move it ahead to center. Shinkarik couldn't come up with it. Sent right back into the Columbus end. But right now the Bobcats doing a nice job of not letting Columbus get the puck in. They finally do. Bersani in, but it's poked right off his stick. And a chance for a clear. Blue Ridge will move it out. This is a good start to a road game by the Blue Ridge Bobcats. Minute 40 in. Columbus really hasn't had a foray into the offensive zone yet. Bobcats have already had a couple. Here's Storjahan up the left side. Denied at the line. Good stick in the lane right there. Wickline looking to turn it back the other way. Shinkarik back in his own end, feeds it across, Underwood on the left side. Storjahan to the blue line, gets it over for Wickline, but the play is offside. 2 minutes into the first period. And the River Dragons just don't seem to have the rhythm just yet in this one. A little bit of a slow start for Columbus. And again, credit where credit's due. You got to like what you're seeing out of Blue Ridge right now so far. They're making it difficult on Columbus. Underwood will dump the puck in from center. In behind the Bobcats net. Stepping over to the far side is Delcart. And he'll go back in behind his own goal. Set things up here on the break. 2:15 into the first. No score. Pass at center. Dumped ahead by Smirnoff to the line. Delcart helping it on the right side with a roller. Puts a shot towards the net. That one wide. Runner comes to the near wing. Sent deep on the cycle. Columbus trying to pick it off, get it onto there. Wickline does get it to center. off of Smirnoff. Jemayev tried to poke it back to the D. It's tied up right in front of that River Dragons bench. Underwood ends up with it. Kirk Underwood chased all the way behind his own net. Goes left side to Bockwell. He goes left side, and now Columbus will carry it in. And trying to dance into the slot, Ryan Hunter was dispossessed. Boy, the Bobcats are very impressive defensively right now. They'll come back on the left side. Montanak trying to do something on the left side as it's played deep. Cycled around there for Hall, just back off the IR. Ends up at the right point, shot coming in, misses the net. Montanak behind the net, tried to send it in front, it's chopped away, ends up with Ryan Hunter. And now, River Dragons have numbers. If they can hurry here, left side McDonald into space, too far in the stretch for Andreoli. Puts it down low, McDonald on the cycle, looking up top. McDonald, slot, Andreoli lost it in his skates. Tried to play it to himself there, couldn't do it. Hunter to the left side. On the loose puck, pokes it to the point, puck kept in. There's a shot coming in. Oh, tipped in traffic and a rebound in front. Andreoli doesn't shoot. He was hooked up, couldn't get it away. Popoff getting it over to the left side. Into the slot, McDonald turning with it. Right point, Popoff. Popoff down the right side, into the slot again for McDonald, who is tied up. Left point, Lehecka holding it in. Into the slot, he gave it up. River Dragons are going for a change here. Now a chance at an odd man, but Blue Ridge bobbled the pass. Back the other way, Petrantonio stepping in on the right side with a shot. He skied it. Round the glass it goes. Bobcats clear the zone. Columbus is still struggling to find the rhythm here early. 4:20 gone in the first. No score. River Dragons and Bobcats. Petrantonio rattles that one in from center. And Petrantonio now in on the forecheck, forcing a turnover. Bersani near side, a shot, save, rebound. Petrantonio again is stopped. Liskowitz able to squeeze the pads and hang on. With the first real offensive opportunities for Columbus here in this hockey game. Liskowitz will have a draw coming up to his left. Wickline in for the faceoff. Storjohn and Jemayev out there with him. Gill and Chinkarik on the points. Blue Ridge able to take that draw and poke it away to center. River Dragons dump it right back in. Liskowitz out to play behind the net. Tried to leave it for his D-man. Turned over, side of the net. Wickline in front, but Jemayev had a stick held and could not shoot. Now back the other way. Vlasov on the right wing. He's pulled down by Shinkarik. No call there. Vlasov centers. There was nobody there for the pass. Now it goes. Blue Ridge will regroup in its own zone. In fact, they'll change the forward unit while doing so. Lead pass ahead to center. That one hit Shinkarik. He was pulled down, so no call there either. All right, we're even. Storjohn, move it out to center. Flip back the other way. Knocked out of the air by Shinkarik. Chased all the way behind his own net. Carter Shinkarik on the right side of Wickline. Cross ice feed. Storjohn will fire it in. Near side corner. Wickline stays in the forecheck while everybody else heads to the bench. Blue Ridge. Left side, Smirnoff. Moving it across on the right wing. Here's a chance for Blue Ridge. Nice job. Push off there on the far side as Bockwell took his man out of the play. Puck stays in. Left pointer's Basie with it. His shot coming in. Colgan a right pad save. Doe getting it back across, moving it out towards center. River Dragons on it. Petrantonio dumping it in. Liskowitz flips it around to the near side corner. Doe back in towards the net, deflected behind. Rolls around to the far side corner. Bersani. Petrantonio leaves it to the left point. Shot coming in. Tip goes to the glass. Back up towards that slot area. Rolling puck is cleared to the line. Not out. Held in left side. Bockwell. His shot deflects to the slot. Off Bersani. That allows Wolf to clear. Down it goes. Underwood chasing. This will be icing. 6:26 gone here in the first. We are scoreless. Shots.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is every single time you take a bite, you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. The Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches. There's no touching it.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy basketball season tickets now.
Back at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you. The Chick-fil-A Midland first period. It is scoreless. Shots are three apiece so far. River Dragons hockey brought to you in part by BKI Accounting, a new age approach to old school accounting, specializing in payroll, bookkeeping, income, and sales taxes for small business. Learn more at BKIaccounting.com. Draw coming up to the right of the Bobcats' goal. Tied up in the circle, one back. He's under with a shot, save made. Big rebound in front. Liskowitz finally able to pull it in. Sequoia Swan was right there and might have had a shot at that puck, but it was rolling and eluded him. So they'll try it again. Drawing into the right of Liskowitz. McDonald in for the faceoff. He wins it back to the left point. Into the high slot, feed to Hunter. His shot, save made. Rebound up in the air past Swan. And knocked away to center. Forecheck pressure here from Blue Ridge as Slahetka trying to move it out of there. Puck stays in a pile on the right wing side. Slahetka trying to battle back for it. Gets it ahead finally to McDonald. He'll flip it out of the zone. And ahead of Hunter on the rush. Hunter in with a shot. And that one deflects in. Is held by Liskowitz. Hunter taking over the glass on the far side by Lindberg, and that's going to draw a crowd. Swan gets over there. Boy, Lindberg just stayed glued to the hip of Ryan Hunter and made sure that he put him into the glass at the end of the ride. All the way on the far side of the ice, Hunter shot the puck from the right wing, and they finished on the left. It's really the first sign of aggression we've seen from either side. But again, right now, the Bobcats have done a pretty good job in the early going here, just letting this sleeping dog lie as far as the River Dragons offense is concerned. Columbus is finally starting to build a little zone time here, but again, props to Blue Ridge. They've just been able to clear that puck out of there. There's a quick shot from the draw wick line, and that's the most challenging save for Liskowitz so far. That puck on the far side boards has moved out. And now the right side is Grant Mentis. A new signing here, wearing 44 with the Bobcats. Puck played ahead at center. It'll be turned back. Ivanov leaving it back to Delcarte. His pass to Daly at center, picked off by Wickline, but he lost it. Now Grant Mentis moving back in, trying to wiggle his way through the high slot. Nothing came out of that. In fact, he just turned it over to Shinkarik, who turns it to center. Bobcats back in on the left side. Here's Vlasov carrying behind the net, out the far side. To the dot, Daly can't hang on. Shot from the point, waved at by the blocker of Colgan. Around it goes. Delcarte keeps it the left point. Gets it right back from Ivanov. Delcarte, wrister, wide of the net. Right point, fed into the slot, and Grant Mentis missed the net with his shot. Might be sensing a theme on this shift right now for Blue Ridge. They're having trouble hitting the frame. Puck on the far side. Gill knocks his man down, now wick line away, and here's a chance for a break in behind the D left side. Jemayev in with a drive, and the save made by Liskowitz as he was out at the top of his crease. I think Jemayev felt more urgency to unload that puck than he actually had in reality. Almost looked like he felt like he was running out of room or time. Maybe he thought he heard footsteps, but the defenseman wasn't quite as close as I think he might have imagined. By the way, he gets the shot on net and the faceoff. Controlled by Blue Ridge in the first heavy hit of the game in the corner there. Delivered by the captain, Josh Petrantonio. Puck the other way, here's Wolf trying to walk in on goal. There's a shot, Colgan over to his right to make the save despite the traffic in front. Now back the other way, it's tipped down by Petrantonio into the right side corner. Bersani over after it. Pokes to the far side. Dolt trying to free himself. Right point Underwood. Rolling puck. His shot tipped to the glass. Rebound ends up on the near side. Here's Underwood down for the point. Slaps at it. Keeps it alive into the dot. Petrantonio to Bersani. Bouncing puck. Can't shoot. Petrantonio out with it. Far side turnaround chance. Liskiewicz the save. And now Bersani getting the attention of four white jerseys in front of the net. Columbus is going to have to come into the aid. As Petrantonio and Doe join the pile. And now Bockwell is tied up with one of the Blue Ridge players. They were giving each other the business. The referee had to step in between him. And let's see, that was Sava Smirnov. Boy, Bockwell's a tough customer. He is not going to take it. I'll tell you that much. Bersani was in front of the net looking for a rebound. And unfortunately for Hunter Bersani, he turned around and he had three white jerseys coming right at him. No penalties on the play. 8:58 into the first, no score. Shots are 8-4 in favor of the River Dragons. Columbus is going to put out McDonald, Hunter, and Andreoli. Slahetka and Popoff on the points. Drawn to the right of Liskiewicz in the Bobcats net. McDonald snaps it back clearly to the left point. Shot coming in. That one hit a leg and still gets towards the net. Poked away by the D there. The Bobcats off the glass and out of play. Faceoff will stay inside the zone, but no delay game penalty. Save big at River City Swing Sets, your local Gorilla Play Sets authorized showroom. We offer lifetime warranty swing sets and basketball goals, swings, slides, and more. Check out RiverCitySwingSets.com for the full lineup. Get your big save at River City Swing Sets with free installation on any swing set purchase from River City Swing Sets by saying, "Go River Dragons." Bobcats win the draw, but turn it over at the line. Andreoli trying to leave it up top. McDonald back for it, but poked away from him to center. Popoff will dump it in. Hunter tags up, and now moves up on the forecheck. Center on the near rim. That one McDonald's put into the slot, but it was tipped away. Columbus trying to turn it back, and they do. Left side. Here's Hunter in over the line with a shot. That one is blocked. Comes back onto the near wing. Hall to the line, not out. Popoff holding it in. McDonald, right point, Popoff. Feeds it right back down the wall. Behind it goes Hunter, took a stick up high, no call there. Hunter after the puck, behind the net. Centering feet, comes all the way up to the point. Popoff pressured up top. Gets it to McDonald on the right half boards. Taken away by Hall. Hall able to move it out of the zone. Columbus will be looking for a change if they can get one here. McDonald at center with the puck. He'll elect to wheel back into his own end. Feet ahead is to Popoff. He steps in over the line with a long wrister. Blocker save. Rebound. Slahetka down low. Trying to chip it in front. It was knocked behind the net. Daly out to center where Popoff turns it right back in. 9.5 to go in the first. Scoreless so far between Columbus and Blue Ridge. Here's Storjohan. Moving it up on the left side and deflected away at the Bobcats line. Blue Ridge back on the attack. Right side in with a wrist shot. Colgan folds down on that one. He'll hold on. And that'll get us to the whistle. And a break here with 9:17 to go in this first period. Scoreless so far. Bobcats and River Dragons. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Hey, hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is every single time you take a bite, you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. The Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches. There's no touching it.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me.
There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win.
Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Hello there, my name is...
And we're back at the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan here with you. Thank you so much for joining me for River Dragons Hockey, brought to you in part by Country Inn & Suites, the official host hotel of the Columbus River Dragons. Faceoff to the left of Colgan. It is controlled by Columbus here. Gill will feed it around to the far side. Jamaff off the dasher. That comes out to center. Storjahan, left side, moving it ahead to Wickline. Here's Wickline down the wall. Hand to the left wing corner, Cody Wickline. Free for Jamaff around the rim to the right point. Held in there, Shinkirk with a shot, tipped on the way through, and that one just wide of the net. Roller back onto the near side corner. Storjahan trying to slide through the check of Daly. And out the far side, Ivanov. Up the right wing to Grant Mentis. He'll step in over the line, looking in front for someone to give it to, put it right into the chest of Jamaff, and he'll leave it off. River Dragons quick regroup up the right side, Shinkirk. Shinkirk in over the line. Right side in. He'll tee it up. Wrist shot just missed. High blocker side. Comes to the left point. Gill tried to force it through traffic. He got it through. And now it's tapped in on net. Liskowitz will hold. And that'll get us a faceoff to the right of the Bobcats net. 8:17 left to go on the first. Shots are 10-5 in favor of the River Dragons. Columbus is going to put out the Petrantonio unit. Bersani will take this faceoff. Bersani battling for it right across the slot, trying to put it on goal, and it ends up Andreoli with a shot and the save made. Puck is held, and well, now Bockwill. One of the Bobcats come together. Underwood's going to come over and have a chat about that as well with Wolf. Certainly a lot of discussion going on here between these two teams. You know, that's the other thing. When you're Blue Ridge and you're looking for an identity, scrappy is an identity. And I know that Coach Bichard likes to say, hey, they're hardworking. They are going to be a team that really, you know, puts on the hard hat, brings a lunch pail, tries to beat you that way. But, man, scrappy goes along with that. And if you're team tough, that goes a long way. Guys want to play for each other when they know that everybody else wearing that same jersey has their back. It's important. Puck dumped down into the River Dragons end. No icing here. Bockwill feeding it back around towards Andreoli. Andreoli up the right side. He'll get it across. Bouncing puck at center. Tapped in by Petrantonio. 7:37 to go in the first. No score. River Dragons and the Bobcats. Puck out to center. Underwood on it. Dill will move it back across. And here's a feed up towards McDonald in on goal. And his shot is held by Liskowitz. While we've got a moment, let's take a break. 10 seconds along the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2 Fort Moore Columbus and W295 AY Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
Face off to the right of the Bobcats goal. McDonald wins it over to the wall, but Hunter couldn't come up with it. Pass ahead. That banks past Hall out to center. Montanac dumping it into the left wing corner, takes a shoulder for his efforts, playing back up the near side. Hall cut it off and ends up right back with Popoff. Comes back to him a third time off the dasher. This time it does get out. McDonald left side. Hunter trying to cut in wide, looking in front for Popoff, who came down low, and Hunter didn't see him in time to feed him the puck, didn't have his head up. Boy, Popoff was wide open and in behind the D. Now McDonald fights through a pretty good hold over there. Popoff into the left side corner towards Doe. Doe tying it up. Hunter can't get to the puck. Popoff at the left point defending, and he still keeps it in off his shin, and finally it is bounced out as the Bobcats really had to get some effort to get it out, but Popoff is able to walk it back in. Boy, he's at the end of his shift. Good shift there by Jordan Popoff. Columbus will start a change in behind the play. Still scoreless. 6:20 to go in this first period. Grant Mentis, his teammates are offside. Now he dumps it across, but the puck is turned over. River Dragons quickly up the other way. Shinkarikin over the line, right side of Wickline, back up top, and hooked up, unable to shoot again, was Jemayev. He turns it over. Vlasov back on the left wing for the Bobcats. Leaves for Grant Mentis, poked away by Shinkarikin into the near corner. Grant Mentis leaving it on the left side to Daly. Daly, bottom of the circle, try to walk in front, bouncing, puck through the crease out the other side. Columbus ends up with it. Here's Wickline out to center. In over the line, leaving. Shinkarik has traffic. Wrist shot. Liskowitz a save. Hit him in the helmet, and he pops his lid off. And he'll get the whistle with 5:36. Fans don't like it, but goalies, that's what they do now, man. A strap pops, they shake it off. And I've mentioned this before, me being a player safety guy, I think the international game has it right. The goalie gets hit in the head, you blow that play. Stop it right away. I don't mind that at all. I know fans aren't necessarily excited by it, but so Liskowitz getting the gear back together here. Faceoff will come to his left. Columbus controls. Jemayev has to swing it into the right side corner. Storjahan tying it up in the wall. Ivanov in the pile. Wickline finally able to extricate the puck. Move to the far side. Delcart around to the point out to center it goes. Shinkarik lost it in his skates. Had to hurry up and clear to the other side to Gill. Gill tipping it ahead. Wickline couldn't maintain the pass. Daly turning it back for Wolf. Left side is Rister. That block comes back up the slot. Another chance. Whistled wide to the stick side. Left point held in. Basie towards the net. Puck pinballing to the far post. Colgan stretching out. He's able to hold it. That's going to bring a pile at the side of the net. Here we go. Good couple of saves right there from Brendan Colgan. And the first time we've seen a pile here in the River Dragons end. That's going to get us to our last break of the period here. Scoreless draw so far in the first. 4:55 remaining. We're back with more in a moment on River Dragons Hockey.
Hey, I'm Jackie.
Hey, my name is Justice, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A nugget trays is when it's time for football season and time to have the boys over, Chick-fil-A was it. You bite into it and it's juicy, you know, you got flavors popping. Oh, yeah. On any D-A-Y, I need C-F-A.
Hey, y'all. My name is Soraya, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is how easy it is. That convenience of being able to order through the app is just unmatched. When I place that tray down, those nuggets won't be there for long. Everyone loves them.
Peppermint season is back at Tim Hortons with even more peppermint flavor. It's the tastiest, mintiest way to cheers the holidays. Tis the season to treat yourself with any $1 medium latte when you order on the app. Only at Tim Hortons.
Introducing New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. Music to my ears.
You don't have ears.
Starry, it's different.
Back here at the Columbus Civic Center, Tom Callahan here with you. 4:55 to go in the first period. Scoreless so far between the Bobcats and the River Dragons. Shots 13 for Columbus, 7 for Blue Ridge. Fourth meeting of the year between these two teams. River Dragons won the first three, including the only appearance of the season here for Blue Ridge back on December 16th. That was Teddy Bear Toss Night. Columbus shut Blue Ridge out 4-0 that night. By the way, no penalties out of that scrape as we were headed to the break. In fact, I'll go ahead and jinx it right now and tell you we haven't had a power play yet in this game. Although, the rough stuff is picking up a little bit. The referee is actually still over at the Blue Ridge bench. Coach Zemlichka looking for an answer here on something or other. Face off just outside that River Dragons line. On the far side, it's scooped up and walked in by Blue Ridge. A shot, that one whistled wide. Again on the stick side. It's kind of been the theme for Blue Ridge here in this period as they've had chances. They just can't hit the net. Here's Swan on the far side, leaving it back. Bockwell up the wall. Knocked down. Bersani can't get it out of there. Swan pokes it away, however, and now up through center. Sequoia Swan had it hop on him and left it behind. Bockwell trying to get over to the puck. And he cuts it off on the wall. Bersani pushing it out to center. The lines are a bit scrambled right now for the River Dragons. Here's Petrantonio picking it up. He'll walk it in. Trying to shot. That one was blocked by the D. Petrantonio looking for an option. Leaves it to the left point. Now to the right side. Underwood. His shot off a foot goes to the corner. Swan left side with a chance. Around the rim it goes. And now to the right point. Underwood keeping it in. Right half wall. Petrantonio backing up. His shot missed. Left half wall. There's a shot. Bockwell tipped wide of the net by Swan. Under four to go in the first. Still without a goal in this one. As it's cleared out by Blue Ridge, River Dragons trying to push back quickly. Petrantonio right side in with McDonald. Feeds him in space in the right side corner as he is tied up there on the way through to the puck by Yelenskis. We'll turn over to Hunter. Puck to the left point. Fed part of the way down the wall, but again, Blue Ridge able to push it out to center. And now Slahetka, the turnover, back the other way, 3-on-3. Slahetka left side has McDonald up high. His shot off the shoulder of Liskowitz. Wraparound attempt, and that one is stopped on the far side. Boy, Slahetka was going for the wraparound, and he was tied up just in time. Lindbergh moving it out to center. Slahetka chasing, no icing. 3:09 to go in the first. No score. Pop off. Moving it back down low, and now ahead, McDonald at center, turns it over at the line. Grant Mentis stick handles his way in. He's cut off on the far side boards, feeds it deep, Slahetka after it. River Dragons passing it around in their own end, but haven't left the zone yet. Now McDonald will wait behind his own net. He'll leave for Slahetka. Columbus starting a change here. Pass ahead to McDonald. He wanted to get to the bench. So McDonald has to scoop it to an open wing. Now he'll head to the bench. Turned over now up the right side. Here's a chance. Feed to the back door. Grant Mentis could not connect on that one. Vlasov sent it across, but no connection there. Petrantonio the other way, meanwhile, beats out an icing. Centers to Bersani. Cuts to the backhand. Liskowitz the save. Puck into the far side corner. Cleared out to center. Grant Mentis, did he tip it? No, that'll be icing. 1:59 to go here in this first period. Starting to open up a little bit going both ways. Hopefully it doesn't get too lax defensively in the Columbus end. River Dragons and WTVM are teaming up for a coat drive from 6 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. to help benefit Valley Rescue Mission Wednesday, January 10th. River Dragons players will be in attendance collecting donations from 3 to 6, and every person who donates receives a ticket voucher for an upcoming River Dragons home game. That's Wednesday, January 10th, in front of the WTVM studios located at 1909 Winton Road in Columbus. Bobcats looking to move it out to center. They do. Jemayev on a bouncer, back into his own end, knocked down. Plays it back to the DU, dangerous place right in front of the net. Good thing the River Dragons are able to get away with that one. Gill knocks it out to center. Columbus steps in right side. Storjahan leaves Jemayev slot. Here's a chance, and that one is ripped wide by Shinkarik. Boy, he was trying to go glove, just couldn't find it. Puck tied up in behind the net. Wickline over after it. Wickline on the right side. Tying up Daly on the half boards. Puck pulled onto there. Bobcats looking to clear. And Shinkarik down for the point. Knocks his man off the puck. Turned over left side. Centering feed. And that one is taken away by Blue Ridge. Here's Volpe. Stretch ahead to center on the right side. Chance from the off angle. That one is tipped to the glass. Around it goes towards the left point. Basie will hold it in. Jemayev. Send it behind his own net. Turns it over in the process. Fed to the high slot. A shot and a block there by Gill. Volpe to the right point. That one is cleared out through center. 45 seconds ago in the period. Scoreless between Blue Ridge and Columbus. Smirnov at the line. Steps in on the left wing. High slot, Smirnoff will dump it to the far side corner. Over after it, Martin. Behind the net, Shinkarik. Up the near wall, Doe can't clear it. Kept in by Nicoletti down for the left point. Doe knocks him down, took it away. Bounces it to the far side, hopped over Gill's stick. Second effort, Gill has a man draped on him, but gets it to the line, not out. Kept in, shot coming in, gloved down by Colgan. He says that's enough of this silliness. 9.8 seconds to go in the first period. Scoreless so far. Coming up in our first period intermission, we'll have Kirk Underwood joining us. We'll have a chat with Kirk. Heading into the new year here. Happy Hockey New Year to you. First game of 2024. Puck drop. Blue Ridge controlling, trying to make something out of it. Hall on the right side. McDonald in that pile as well. And that will be the end of the first period. So this one, yeah, goes by in a breeze. No scoring to tell you about here. Shots 15-7. And the River Dragons and the Bobcats actually play a pretty darn good opening 20 minutes here for both teams. And if I'm Blue Ridge, I'm very pleased with the way that opening 20 went. That is a good, boring road period. You don't mind that at all. So what we'll do now is we will take a break and we will step on into our first period intermission report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. When we come back, we will hear from Kirk Underwood. Then, of course, we have a look at the Zelmo Zip-In Out-of-Town scoreboard coming your way. And plenty of action going on in and around the FBHL tonight. We'll update the NHL, even World Juniors. Gold medal, bronze medal games were today. Plenty more coming your way in just a moment. Scoreless after one. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
You know John Deere means quality and reliability in the field. But did you know just how affordable quality equipment can be? Right now at SunSouth, when you come in for a test drive on a new 1 through 3 Series tractor, we'll give you a free John Deere hat and mug. And check out the John Deere 1 Series tractors at SunSouth for as low as $100.
Welcome back here in the first period intermission report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. We're joined by Kirk Underwood. Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely, buddy. Well, I want to talk a little bit about we're flipping the calendar page of 2024. So let's start off. Does Kirk Underwood have any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, I think the biggest one is just gotta really try to bear down and try to do all the small things to win a championship, you know, working out every single day and really bringing my A game to the rink. I think it's just as simple as that.
You know, it's interesting. I think a lot of people feel like the life of a pro athlete, oh, it's easy, you practice, then you've got the day free. But I mean, you guys, it's about nutrition, it's about working out, it's about proper rest. It really, I mean, it's a full-time job.
Yeah, it absolutely is. I think I have maybe a little bit of a leg up considering I have a degree in kinesiology. But yeah, it is. It is a full-time job for sure. There's a lot behind the scenes that people don't see.
Talk a little bit about having that degree in kinesiology. What does that mean exactly? And how does that help you?
To put it in simpler terms, it's essentially exercise science or pre-physical therapy or med degree. But it gave me a lot of background on how to really properly take care of my body and exercise right and fuel it correctly. But yeah, it was something that I was truly passionate about, and obviously it supported my dream in hockey too.
Talk, if you will, about now into 2024. The River Dragons come in tied first place with Carolina. I'm sure it's nice to be atop the standings, but certainly there's probably a few more things you'd like to fix. What is the team focused on for the second half here?
Yeah, I think ultimately everyone knows that we have more in the tank. When it comes down to it, it's about execution. When we have our chances, we need to bury them. We do a really good job for 90% of the play, and then now what we really need to bear down on is really putting the puck in the back of the net every single chance and making teams pay and knowing that when they make a mistake, we're going to capitalize.
All right, Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it. Best of luck in 2024.
Thank you.
All right, back with more of the first period intermission report in just a moment. Welcome back here in the first period intermission report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. We're joined by Kirk Underwood. Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely, buddy. Well, I want to talk a little bit about we're flipping the calendar page of 2024. So let's start off. Does Kirk Underwood have any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, I think the biggest one is just gotta really try to bear down and try to do all the small things to win a championship, you know, working out every single day and really bringing my A game to the rink. I think it's just as simple as that.
You know, it's interesting. I think a lot of people feel like the life of a pro athlete, oh, it's easy, you practice, then you've got the day free. But I mean, you guys, it's about nutrition, it's about working out, it's about proper rest. It really, I mean, it's a full-time job.
Yeah, it absolutely is. I think I have maybe a little bit of a leg up considering I have a degree in kinesiology. But yeah, it is. It is a full-time job for sure. There's a lot behind the scenes that people don't see.
Talk a little bit about having that degree in kinesiology. What does that mean exactly? And how does that help you?
To put it in simpler terms, it's essentially exercise science or pre-physical therapy or med degree. But it gave me a lot of background on how to really properly take care of my body and exercise right and fuel it correctly. But yeah, it was something that I was truly passionate about, and obviously it supported my dream in hockey too.
Talk, if you will, about now into 2024. The River Dragons come in tied first place with Carolina. I'm sure it's nice to be atop the standings, but certainly there's probably a few more things you'd like to fix. What is the team focused on for the second half here?
Yeah, I think ultimately everyone knows that we have more in the tank. When it comes down to it, it's about execution. When we have our chances, we need to bury them. We do a really good job for 90% of the play, and then now what we really need to bear down on is really putting the puck in the back of the net every single chance and making teams pay and knowing that when they make a mistake, we're going to capitalize.
All right, Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it. Best of luck in 2024.
Thank you.
All right, back with more of the First Period Intermission Report in just a moment. Welcome back here in the First Period Intermission Report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. We're joined by Kirk Underwood. Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely, buddy. Well, I want to talk a little bit about we're flipping the calendar page of 2024. So let's start off. Does Kirk Underwood have any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, I think the biggest one is just gotta really try to bear down and try to do all the small things to win a championship, you know, working out every single day and really bringing my A game to the rink. I think it's just as simple as that.
You know, it's interesting. I think a lot of people feel like the life of a pro athlete, oh, it's easy, you practice, then you've got the day free. But I mean, you guys, it's about nutrition, it's about working out, it's about proper rest. It really, I mean, it's a full-time job.
Yeah, it absolutely is. I think I have maybe a little bit of a leg up considering I have a degree in kinesiology. But yeah, it is. It is a full-time job for sure. There's a lot behind the scenes that people don't see.
Talk a little bit about having that degree in kinesiology. What does that mean exactly? And how does that help you?
To put it in simpler terms, it's essentially exercise science or pre-physical therapy or med degree. But it gave me a lot of background on how to really properly take care of my body and exercise right and fuel it correctly. But yeah, it was something that I was truly passionate about, and obviously it supported my dream in hockey too.
Talk, if you will, about now into 2024. The River Dragons come in tied first place with Carolina. I'm sure it's nice to be atop the standings, but certainly there's probably a few more things you'd like to fix. What is the team focused on for the second half here?
Yeah, I think ultimately everyone knows that we have more in the tank. When it comes down to it, it's about execution. When we have our chances, we need to bury them. We do a really good job for 90% of the play, and then now what we really need to bear down on is really putting the puck in the back of the net every single chance and making teams pay and knowing that when they make a mistake, we're going to capitalize.
All right, Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it. Best of luck in 2024.
Thank you.
All right, back with more of the First Period Intermission Report in just a moment. Welcome back here in the First Period Intermission Report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. We're joined by Kirk Underwood. Kirk, thanks for joining us. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely, buddy. Well, I want to talk a little bit about we're flipping the calendar page of 2024. So let's start off. Does Kirk Underwood have any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, I think the biggest one is just gotta really try to bear down and try to do all the small things to win a championship, you know, working out every single day and really bringing my A game to the rink. I think it's just as simple as that.
You know, it's interesting. I think a lot of people feel like the life of a pro athlete, oh, it's easy, you practice, then you've got the day free. But I mean, you guys, it's about nutrition, it's about working out, it's about proper rest. It really, I mean, it's a full-time job.
Yeah, it absolutely is. I think I have maybe a little bit of a leg up considering I have a degree in kinesiology. But yeah, it is. It is a full-time job for sure. There's a lot behind the scenes that people don't see.
Talk a little bit about having that degree in kinesiology. What does that mean exactly? And how does that help you?
To put it in simpler terms, it's essentially exercise science or pre-physical therapy or med degree. But it gave me a lot of background on how to really...
Period Intermission Report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. Equipment for those that do. Want to remind everybody, our next Eat with the River Dragons event at Applebee's will be at the Phoenix City location. That's on Highway 280, and it'll be Monday, January 15th at 6 p.m. It's a great chance to meet the team and get pictures and autographs. Don't forget, right now, a $10 bonus gift card for every $50 in gift cards you buy. And so looking forward to seeing you out there at Applebee's, and a great chance to meet the team and hang out a little bit. Have a good time. And the River Dragons right now scoreless with the Blue Ridge Bobcats after one period of play. So we take a look back over the numbers from that period. It was kind of an interesting one in that it got a little feisty in pockets, but not much. The physical play wasn't too crazy, but no power plays for either side. No goals for either side. It did towards the end of the first, I think, get a little more contentious, but interestingly, for the River Dragons, it seemed like it took them a little while to get the zone time going. Blue Ridge started off pretty well, and for the first shift or two, really did a nice job keeping the Dragons from going anywhere and mounting a couple challenges of their own towards the River Dragons net. But what's interesting, you look at seven shots for the Bobcats, they probably had around 20, maybe even 22 attempts in that first period. They missed the net a lot with their shots. And that, number one, makes an easier night for the goaltender. But number two, can really result in some turnovers and a lack of puck possession. But guys, and we heard Coach Bichard kind of bemoan that in the pregame interview about how when you try to pick corners, you're trying to put the puck into such a tiny little area, it's a hard shot to make. Instead of shooting maybe to score, but maybe for a rebound, trying to generate just a puck towards the net, make something happen, get the ball rolling offensively. And I think the River Dragons are trying to do a little bit more of that now than they were earlier in the game. But towards the end of the first period, we started seeing them get pucks towards the net more, making a few more sensible plays, some dumps towards corners. Columbus was giving the puck up in the slot a lot. They were putting pucks through sometimes with nobody there. Other times, they were just kind of putting a hopper in towards that slot area. And more often than not, it wasn't connecting. And so meaningful puck possession, I think, is what the River Dragons need to strive for here in period number two. Being able to set up the offense is one thing. Being able to generate maybe some grade-A scoring chances and finally find a way to beat Owen Leskowitz is another. So no power plays in the period. Shots were 15-7 in favor of Columbus. Let's take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. As a busy night in the FPHL tonight. Into the second period, we find at First Arena that Elmira and Danbury are still scoreless. And at Watertown Arena, after one period of play, Motor City and the Watertown Wolves. That one is scoreless as well. Port Huron has taken a 1-0 lead on the road over the Carolina Thunderbirds. So that's a good start for the Prowlers in that hockey game. And then coming up, or actually just getting underway at the top of the hour, just moments ago, we've got Zydeco at the Seawolves. And in fact, the Zydeco were out to a 1-0 first period lead in that game. So good on the Zydeco there in the early going. National Hockey League, two games going on right now. Blackhawks up to a 1-0 lead over the New Jersey Devils midway through the second period. Jason Dickinson, his 13th. Capitals with a 2-1 lead on the Hurricanes. Dowd and Strome for the Capitals. Brent Burns, his 7th for Carolina. And then at 10 o'clock tonight, Jets at the Ducks. NCAA men's basketball, number 4, UConn, has come back and are leading Butler late in the second half with just under 2 minutes to go, 79-74. The Huskies have pulled back into the lead, tipping off here at the bottom of the hour, number 1 Purdue and number 9 Illinois. In the NFL, two games tomorrow as the regular season comes to a close, Steelers at the Ravens, Texans at the Colts. Then on Sunday in the 1 o'clock window, you have Browns, Bengals, Vikings, Lions, Jags, Titans, Jets, Patriots, Falcons at the Saints, Bucks at the Panthers. 4 o'clock window, you've got Bears at Packers, Broncos at Raiders, Eagles at Giants, Seahawks at Cardinals, Chiefs at Chargers, Rams at 49ers, and Cowboys at Commanders. And then rounding out the regular season, Sunday night, Bills are at the Dolphins. Finally, in the World Junior Championship, an unprecedented comeback by Czechia, the fastest 4 goals in World Juniors history. And that helps them come back on Finland in the bronze medal game. Czechia, 8-5 winners over Finland. And, boy, it's unbelievable. They are calling it an astonishing comeback. There's video highlights of it all over the place. Definitely worth watching. And Czechia comes back to just absolutely stun Finland. And in the gold medal game, the United States, the pre-tournament favorite, taking on Sweden, the host country, and the United States leading at 3-2 after 2 periods of play into the third period. They pull away. 6-2, USA wins it over Sweden, and the Americans take gold at the World Junior Championship. Time for us to take a break, and when we come back, we'll have second period action on tap here for you. That's it for the Sun-South John Deere first period intermission. 20 minutes in the books, and we have no score between the River Dragons and the Bobcats. Back with more in a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Applebee's All You Can Eat Riblets, Shrimp, and Boneless Wings are back for just $14.99. Applebee's, you know that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me. There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
For second period action, Tom Callahan here with you as we have made it through the first 20 without a goal. 0-0, Blue Ridge and Columbus. So two teams return to the ice here. Pretty good crowd on hand here tonight, Friday night. And, of course, tomorrow night we're back at it again, 7:05 puck drop. 6:30 on the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Tickets on sale for all remaining River Dragons home games through the Civic Center box office. So if you're here tonight, you can always pick some up on your way out. Or if you want to come down tomorrow, you can pick them up. And, of course, online at Ticketmaster.com. River Dragons hockey brought to you in part by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the River Dragons, and Zelmo Zippin, the official fuel provider of the Columbus River Dragons. No goals, no penalties in that opening 20. Just 15 shots for Columbus, 8 for the Bobcats. River Dragons rolling right to left here in front of our broadcast location for period number 2. It'll be McDonald, now with Andreoli and Hunter. Puck down, and it's one back by McDonald. We're underway. Columbus controlling the draw. Slahetka skating it in on the left side into the corner. Looking to center. It's deflected around to the right wing side. Andreoli. He'll chip it down low for McDonald. Shoves it to the far corner. Down for the right point is Popoff. In a pile there, McDonald. Back to Popoff. Wanted to go back to McDonald. They jam away at it on the wall. Andreoli over to support on the boards. Bouncing free in the slot. Blue Ridge will clear it out. Slahetka turning it back. McDonald left side. Wanted Hunter. Poked off his stick at the line. Right back in. It's dumped to the near side. But again, Blue Ridge to the clear. Dumped in from center by Oakes. In behind the net. Popoff reversing it around. Slahetka gave it up. Right side, here's a chance. Martin down low, skates behind the net, backhand feed. It's taken away by Slahetka. He'll just ease that one out of the zone to center. Nicoletti on it, back at his own line. River Dragons starting a change here. Now back up the left side. Columbus in over the line. Here's Hunter in the slot with a shot deflected to the far glass. Storjahan out there with Wickline. Storjahan chops it behind the net, looking for Wickline. Cleared away before he got there. Around the rim, it comes to center. Turned over to Gill. Gill right side, Shinkarik back ahead. Puck tipped on into the Blue Ridge end. Kept in at the line. Storjahan lost it in the skates. Hall the other way. Blue Ridge attacking on the left wing. The centering feed deflected away by Gill. Left side, Nicoletti pinching from the point. He'll put it to the side of the net. A shot. Colgan the save right on the doorstep on that Yelensky's backhander. Now Jemayev quickly the other way up the right side. Cutting in wide. Jemayev behind the net, had it poked off his stick. Puck still free in the slot. And that one sent to the far side wall. Still not out. Wickline battling, and now there's a player down in the slot for Blue Ridge as the puck comes in on goal, and that looks like Joel Frazee fell in the slot. I don't think there was anybody near him. He's okay as he gets up and heads towards the bench. I did not see what happened there. But he took his time getting up there. And Liskowitz just covered the puck, let him get off the ice. Looks like he's all right. Nobody's tending to him, but well, that was a strange one. 2:08 gone in the second, no score here. Faceoff to the left of the Bobcats net. Columbus trying to keep it in. It goes off Petrantonio. Stays in the right half boards. Now in front. Doe on a rolling puck to the backhand. Liskowitz shuts it down. Nice glove save right there. Doe cutting across left to right. Picked it up on his forehand. Went to the backhand. And Liskowitz out to his left. Big glove stop right there. His best of the game so far. Face off, dropped, it went off Bersani. On that far side dot, Blue Ridge able to move it away to center. Bersani tried to keep it in, could not. Sent back in. River Dragons must tag up. Delcarte has pressure. Right side, he finds Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis looking to move it ahead. Fell as he did so. That allows Austin Doe to come back towards the puck. Now it's turned over side of the net, right to Colgan. He'll flop the mitt on it and hang on. Both teams will change it up. Five fresh skaters out on either side. Draw to the left of the River Dragons goal. McDonald. Now with Andreoli and Hunter. Popoff and Lehetka on defense. McDonald able to win the drawback. Popoff after the rolling puck. He's put into the glass. Puck turned over on the far side. Bobcats in the slot. There's a chance. That is blocked by Slahetka. And now moved away. McDonald to center. To Andreoli. In over the line. Wrist shot. Blocker save. Rebound cleared. Back down the ice. This will be an icing call. 3:07 gone in the second. Columbus has had a couple of chances here in the early going, but still no goals on either side of that scoreboard. McDonald in for the draw. Looking to pull this one back over his right side. He digs in for it, and he does not this time. Hunter, though, keeps the puck into the wall. And now it's cleared again. An attempt off Hunter and out to center. Columbus on the regroup, back in its own end. Stretch on the right side. Here's Hunter. He's in behind the D. McDonald going to the net. Hunter over to McDonald. Pass tipped on the way. Andreoli left side corner. McDonald in there. Now we get a whistle. And faceoff will stay here. In the Bobcat zone. Andreoli, I think, wanted that play to be kept alive. It's funny, we talked on the coaches show this week with Jerome Bichard about how the River Dragons have seen basically a situation where a lot of plays have gone on 15, maybe 20 seconds sometimes in the corner. Referees not blowing it dead, but there, that was a fairly quick whistle. A little bit of a change in tone from what we've seen maybe the last month or so. Draw to the right of the Bobcats goal. Nicoletti ends up with it. It's Frazee won it back to him. Near side, Yelensky's trying to clear. Cannot bounce back in towards Nicoletti. Nicoletti on the far side. Chipped out to center. Bobcats trying to left wing on the attack here. A centering attempt picked off by Gill. He'll jam it away to the wall. A clear one off the back of Storjahan. Doesn't get out. Hall in with a chance, but that one is blocked by Shinkarik. Hall chasing to the far side. Storjahan over, leaving it for Shinkarik. He put it right to the front of his own net. Colgan alertly will get on top of that puck and hang on for the whistle. 4:09 into the second. Want to say hello to any other FPHL fans that might be checking us out tonight. Binghamton, the only team not in action this evening. The Black Bears currently with the highest point total in the FPHL. River Dragons and the Black Bears will not see each other in the regular season this year. Columbus, in fact, doesn't see a couple of teams. Danbury is another one. Elmira is set to come in, however, during this little homestand here. We'll see them next weekend. Grant Mentis will dump it in right to Colgan, and he'll just go into the butterfly, hang on to the puck. As a matter of fact, that's the only time the River Sharks and the River Dragons meet is next weekend. That'll be right here in Columbus with a draw coming in to the left of Colgan here. But no Watertown in the regular season, no Binghamton, no Danbury. We will see the Michigan teams, just have not as of yet. River Dragons able to move it to center. Big collision there between Underwood and Daly as the puck dumped in, and that one is just punched out of play by Liskiewicz. 4:39 gone here in the second. River Dragons and the Bobcats are scoreless. Faceoff will come down to the left of the Bobcats' goal. The second period is brought to you by WOW Internet. The Columbus River Dragons proud to partner with WOW again this season. Team up with WOW Internet and YouTube TV. It's a good deal for good sports fans. Go Dragons! Columbus keeps the faceoff in. Bach with a shot, missed the net. Around to the right point, Underwood. He is able to hold it down low. Doe looked to center, hit the back of the net. Hunter on the right side. to Doe. McDonald on the cycle, looking up top. Left point, here's Bockwill in with a drive and a save there. Liskowitz. And that one disappear in the gear. Yeah, Liskowitz not afraid to get out on top of that crease. Cut down the angle, make himself bigger, and he's already a pretty big guy. But he gets out there right on top of you and uses that large frame to block even more of the net. Faceoff will be to his right. Puck to the left, pointers pop off over to the right side on the line. Slahetka has to just slap it deep. Centering attempt, Hunter. Back up top, Slahetka. Into the slot, tipped by McDonald, and that one is blocked away by Liskowitz. Blue Ridge trying to figure out a way to get the puck out of the zone. Basie off the far wall. And now Blue Ridge is able to get it to center. Slahek able to recover, though. Boy, he's lucky he did. That could have been awkward on that far side, but Popoff back. Smirnoff had it cleared away. Puck to the far side. Austin Doe on it. It's interesting. The River Dragons have mixed up the lines, then they put them back together, then they mixed them up a little bit again. And I'm just trying to figure out if that's because of shift changes or if they are perhaps trying to turn these lines over a little bit. Here's Hunter in on the left side, leaving it for McDonald. He looks up top, puck to the right point, pop off, forced it through, but wide. Bobcats trying to clear, Smirnoff to the line, second effort, gets it out. Let's go, Dragons! Oaks will track back after it into his own end. Blue Ridge to center. Oaks on the right side, takes a shoulder there from Hunter as the puck is dumped in. River Dragons mid-change. Hunter left side. Lugs it through center. He'll dump it across in over the line. Bersani with a shot forced to the glass, and he goes crashing into the net. And that's going to bring us to a stop here. 6:24 gone here in the second period. Still scoreless. River Dragons and the Bobcats. More coming your way in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Get ready to hoop it up this season.
Honey, what is that?
It's our new internet. I had to have it.
Oh, wow.
Good internet.
Good internet.
Choose WOW and get internet 500 for just $39.99 a month and get $100 on us.
Wow.
So much to love. For a limited time, get internet 1 gig for just $50 a month.
Wow.
And we're back at the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan here with you, Columbus River Dragons Hockey. We played 6 minutes, 24 seconds into the second period. Brought to you by WOW Internet. The Chick-fil-A Midland Kissin 99.3 family four-pack includes four tickets to a River Dragons game, four hot dogs, four popcorns, four Pepsi products, and four coupons for free Chick-fil-A sandwiches. That's over $100 in value for just $40. Our next family four-pack game, January 13th, against the Elmira River Sharks. Available only at the River Dragons office, 706-507-4625, 507-4625, or stop by during regular business hours. Bobcats look to move it ahead. Your scoreless draw so far in this one. Puck into the right side corner. Centering attempt poked away by the goal stick of Colgan, but the puck's still there. A chance backhanded wide. Boy, point blank there. Hall just couldn't quite get it to go. Now put up to the point, picked off by Wickline. He'll move it ahead. Here's Shinkarik into the play, leaving off looking for Jemayev. Jemayev into a pile. It's cleared out. Gill. Little flip into space, didn't get much on it. Had to go play it again, but he turned it over. Yelensky's, but Gill able to fight and get it back. Bobcats will dump it right back in. Colgan out to play it up the near side. Around it comes to Jemayev. He tips it on. Storjahan, left side, cross ice dump, right wing corner. Wickline to go get it. Dump cart takes it away. River Dragons will change it up. 7.5 gone here in the second. No score. There's a chance, and that one off the mitt of Colgan ends up in the near corner. Now Bockwell behind the net reverses it around Andreoli. Andreoli up the left side. Tried to push it deeper, could not. Back the other way, Grant Mentis in over the line. He'll feed it in front. Blocked off escape. Puck is cleared to center. Grant Mentis recovers it there. Moves it across left side. Daly walks in. Nice job by Gill to disrupt the shot with a stick. Petrantonio clears off the dasher. Bobcats on a regroup. River Dragons finally trying to get that D changed out here. Columbus looking to push it ahead. Bersani into space. Daly took it away. Daly right side to Grant Mentis. He cuts in over the line. Left wing flips it into the slot off Bersani. He'll turn it the other way as Petrantonio banks it behind him. Petrantonio had to stop at the line. Bersani moves up on the forecheck. Bersani wraps his man up in the corner. This puck played around to the far side. Hunter on the right side, keeping it on the half boards. Hunter couldn't step through the traffic, cleared off the glass and out. Puck on the near side, Bockwell will fire it in. Cross corner it goes, McDonald up after it. He'll backhand it behind the net, looking for Austin Doe. Puck on the far side, around the rim to the right point, kept in by Underwood. McDonald, slot, Doe, wrist shot, save made, Liskowitz, and he holds on. .904 gone in the second. Still looking for the first goal of this game. Haven't had a power play for either side in this game. But we have had some pretty good battles. Some nice defensive plays. McDonald, Doe, Hunter out there together. McDonald looks like he's going to try to pull this back to Hunter, top of the circle. Doe steps in to help with the draw, but it's won back by the Bobcats. Nicoletti will carry it ahead. Onto the right wing side. Yalensky's at the line. Pokes it in. Is the play offside? It is. That allows Popoff all the time of the world to turn it back through center. Gets it to McDonald. Following up the play, Doe, but the puck was over his stick. Back to Slahetka. Ahead, McDonald. Left side, leaving it for Doe. Back for McDonald. Left side corner. Behind the net, around to the far side. Hunter. Backdoor. Doe scores! Great pass by Ryan Hunter as Doe cut down the slot at the far post. He puts it away on the blocker side of Liskowitz. The River Dragons strike first. It's 1-0. And Justin McDonald should pick up an assist on that goal as well. And if he does, that is his 300th. FPHL point. .938 time of the goal. That's his ninth of the year for Doe. Indeed, McDonald picking up the assist. That is his 300th FPHL point. Congratulations to Justin McDonald. Left side, here's Bersani in on the wall. Backhand towards the net. Liskowitz pokes it away. River Dragons have finally broken the ice here. Now let's see what happens if the game opens up a little from here. Although our next whistle, we're going to get a media timeout. But in the meantime, Columbus may try to use this momentum here. So bringing ahead left side, here's Storjahan. Over to the right wing, play is offside, but the Bobcats just turn it back the other way anyway. Pop off with a collision at center, jars that puck loose. Columbus on it again. That pass missed, down the ice it goes, and that will be an icing call. 9:17 to go here in the second. 1-0 River Dragons in the lead. Back with the war in a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Watch out, watch out.
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah!
So fast, so reliable, so much to love. For a limited time, get Internet 1 gig for just $50 a month.
Wow. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me.
Applebee's all-you-can-eat riblets, shrimp, and boneless wings are back for just $14.99. Applebee's. You know, that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Good internet. For a limited time, get super fast internet and YouTube TV starting at just $82.98 per month.
Wow.
One nothing. River Dragons in the lead here halfway home in this one. 9:17 to go in the second period. Shots 20-11 in favor of Columbus. If you're just joining us, with an assist on the goal, not only does Justin McDonald extend his scoring streak to 11 games, that is FPHL point number 300 for Justin McDonald. So congratulations to him on the milestone. Faceoff will be to the right of Colgan. Five on five hockey, as we have been the entire time. Not a power play in sight in this one yet. And we just got our first goal. It was Austin Doe. That's his ninth of the season, his 24th point. And good to see Ryan Hunter get back on the sheet. Faceoff pushed over to the far wall. River Dragons trying to clear it out. They cannot. Puck is dumped into the netting by Blue Ridge. See if they're going to keep that faceoff inside. It looks like they will, so must have deflected off a River Dragons player as they make the announcement in-house for McDonald. Just gives a little wave to the crowd. Blue Ridge controlling the draw, but it escapes to center. Shinkarik, left side here, Storjahan, trying to play it across. Dumped in on the wing, Jemayev. Jemayev in with a shot and a glove save, Leskowitz. He'll pull that one in. Hang on for a faceoff to his right. Storjahan, Wickline, Jemayev up front. Shinkarik and Gill on the points. 8:55 to go in the second. 1-0 Columbus. Shots 21-11 in favor of the River Dragons. On the left side, here's Wickline with a wrister. Forced wide of the net. Shinkarik down for the right point. He'll swing it around low. Storjahan up to the left point to Gill. Gill walks around one, feeds right side, and Shinkarik got a roll off his stick. Shinkarik tried to feed it in front once again. Had it just kind of go off the heel. Maybe they're playing with a super ball out there. I don't know. Right side, back comes Blue Ridge. Hall dancing in space. Tried to leave it for Yelinski's, but just missed him entirely. River Dragons feed back the other way. The puck goes down, and Wickline able to beat out the icing. That forces a poke to the corner by the goaltender Leskowitz. Recovered by Storjahan. Right side, Jemayev. Jemayev to Storjahan. Storjahan looking up top, cross ice feed, and the pass behind the defender. And now back the other way comes Blue Ridge breaking up the right side. Yelinski's has room, walks in, cuts to the slot, a shot, he missed the net. Rebound, bouncing in front, and somehow Colgan able to keep it out. Turn the other way, 2-on-0. Here comes Austin Doe. Up to Storjahan. Doe moving in a goal to the back, can't save. Rebound, they score. Storjahan puts away the rebound off the right pad of the goaltender Leskowitz. And the River Dragons are up 2-0. Big save in one end leads directly to a goal in the other. Brendan Colgan with a nice stop in his own end. And then the River Dragons come back down and convert. Austin Doe almost found the daylight as he tried to do a little lay-by, leave it behind. But Storjahan right there following up the play. He scores on the rebound off that Doe chance. His eighth of the year, and Columbus up 2-0.
Four.
Doan the only assist on that goal. They might add another one later. Your bank pass goes all the way in on Liskowitz. He'll pull it in. Would have been an icing otherwise, but he hangs on. That one right on net. Well, how about the River Dragons here? It was quiet in this game for the most part, but now Columbus has scored twice in a span of just under 2.5 minutes. Face off to the right of the Bobcats goal. Poke back to the left point. Bockwell steps down the boards, trying to keep it in. Hunter on the left side. The left point, Bockwell. His shot is blocked away by Grant Mentis. Ends up out at center. Columbus regrouping quickly. Left side feed, here's Hunter. Hunter slot to Doe. He's knocked down off the puck by Daly. Bobcats charge ahead. Feed on the right side. Daly in over the line. Lets a shot go. Blocker save. Rebound swept away before Grant Mentis could get to it. Nice play by Underwood. Banked off the glass to center. Basie will turn it back in. And Colgan, a little bit of miscommunication back there. Finally turned away as McDonald around the rim, but not out of the zone. Kept into the slot. Here's a chance for Wolf cutting to the backhand, and he fed it away from Basie out. Wolf, I don't know why he didn't shoot that puck when he had the chance, but it literally cleared the zone. Wolf is back in now, feeds it over far side. Tipped in on goal. Colgan a save on the redirect. Fed up top, Basie to the right point. Oaks lets a wrister go, blocked in front by Bockwell. Fed back around to the right point. Oaks again, a shot. Colgan the save, hit him in the mask. And now McDonald chips it out off the glass. And McDonald, left wing, has help in front. Tried to feed it across. Rebound up top. Here's Andreoli, and he scores! Liskowitz gambled and lost with a poke check. Thought he could reach the puck. Andreoli was able to pull it out of his skates, get it to a shooting position, and all he had to do was tuck it in the open net. He does it, and it's 3-0 River Dragons. So good to see Carson Andreoli back on the score sheet. 14:05, time of the goal. Andreoli's second goal of the season. Now the breakdown starting a little bit here for Blue Ridge. They've got to rally their confidence. So McDonald picks up another point with the assist. Icing the call. Face off back into the Blue Ridge zone for Andreoli. That's his first goal since October 27th at Baton Rouge. And his first point since an assist December 15th at Mississippi. Of course, he missed four games with time on the IR back in mid-November. It's taken him a little while to get it back in gear here, but boy, glad to see him put that one in here tonight. Hopefully that gets him going back in the right direction offensively. Blue Ridge looking to move the puck ahead. Popoff kicks it away. Petrantonio off the glass and out. Bersani at center. Tried to play it ahead. It came back to him. He'll try the left side. Andreoli in. Andreoli on the wall. Stumbles. Lost the puck. Cleared to center. Popoff waiting. He'll send it around the rim. 5 to go in the second. 3-0 Columbus in the lead. Now the first penalty of the game is Bersani. A heavy check on the glass. He's going to get penalized for that. As he goes into Lindbergh, they're going to call boarding. So when we come back, Bobcats to the power play. River Dragons leading it 3-0 here in the second period with 4:55 to go. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Honey, what is that?
It's our new internet. I had to have it.
Oh, wow.
Good internet.
Good internet.
Choose WOW and get internet 500 for just $39.99 a month and get $100 on us.
Wow. Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me? There's only one way to settle this.
Rock. Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Good internet. For a limited time, get super fast internet and YouTube TV starting at just $82.98 per month.
4:55 to go in the second period, and Hunter Bersani is in the Abercrombie bonding penalty box. The River Dragons will try to spring him onto their first power play of the game for either side. Coming into tonight's game, dead last on the power play for the Bobcats at 12.2%. River Dragons first on the kill at 85.9%. It's a mismatch on paper, but boy, don't let that fool you. River Dragons need to take care of business here. This is actually a fairly critical power play in this game. It's a 3-0 Columbus lead late in the second. If the Bobcats want to get back in the game, the easiest way to do it is to score in this man advantage. Grant Mentis pressured at the point. He will cough it up. Petrantonio will dump it down. Good start for the kill. Bobcats ahead on the regroup, taking their time, coming up the ice here, right side. Smirnoff cutting in, now he's behind the D. Smirnoff centers, who went off Underwood, right back out the other side. Columbus able to clear. Bobcats move it ahead quickly. Grant Mentis, left side, he'll stop on the half wall. Flips it up top. There's a shot coming in well wide of the net. Hall on it, try to feed the rebound up top, looking for Jelenski's in front. Daly on the left side. Carries it across. Daly into the side with a shot. Oh, boy, deflected. Pinballed its way in and then hit the side of the net. Big hit back in the offensive zone as Hall is knocked down by Bockwill. Hall's got something to say on the way by, but Bockwill, quite frankly, does not care. Wickline backing up at his own end, tried to clear, but that one hit a body, doesn't leave the zone. Puck right in front, swatted away. A second attempt for Wickline. Towards the line, still not out. Jemayev able to poke it ahead, though. Bockwill to center. He's at the end of his shift here. He'll just move it ahead. Tip to Jemayev, right side into the corner. Slapped away from Jemayev, 28 seconds to go on the power play. Bobcats up the right side. Lindbergh moving it in, lost the handle on it, cleared right back out. 10 seconds to go. Bersani up on his skates, ready to get out of that Abercrombie bonding penalty box here. There's a countdown on. 3-2-1. Out he steps. River Dragons have killed it off. Bersani at center, trying to pick up a loose puck. Couldn't come up with it. Frazee with a shot, tipped away to the far wall. Smirnoff with it. On the far side, wheeling in space on the left wing, stops. Cross ice feed is intercepted on the way through, punched ahead. Hunter over skates, but now he gets a feed ahead from Doe. Right side, he's got Shinkarik in with him. Hunter rolling puck, stops, has to go back for it. He'll slow things up and loop high in the zone, try to feed it down low, but that one is recovered by Blue Ridge. Smirnoff ahead at center. Can't do much with it, he's caught from behind. Doe will drop it back to Gill. Gill up the left wing, at center, ahead to Hunter. In over the line, sent back the other way. Grant Mentis with it, coming up on two to go in the second period. 3-0 River Dragons. Shinkarik back. He fans on it as well, and now Grant Mentis looking for a shot. Chance is deflected in on goal, and Colgan will hold. 1:55 to go on the second. 3-0 River Dragons. While we've got a moment, let's take a break. 10 seconds along the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2 Fort Moore, Columbus, and W295 AY Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
Drawn to the right of the River Dragons goal. Storja Hahn in for the faceoff. He wins it back away from Daly. Ends up on the near side. Jemayev out to center. Wickline. Left wing swings it for Jemayev. Oaks tried to clear it back around the rim. Grant Mentis with it. Slahetka all the way down for the point. Couldn't steal it away. Daly on the left side, moving it ahead. Pop off, intercepted that pass. Jemayev knocked down to the far boards. And he's going to hop off the ice here. 1:20 to go in the second. 3-0. River Dragons have opened up the lead here. This is a stump back into the Blue Ridge end. A rolling puck. Daly after it, trying to leave it behind the net. Here's Basie. Left side, slides it through center off Bersani. Pop off back towards Bersani, who's tied up, kicking at it. Can't move it ahead. Andreoli will carry it back into his own end. Andreoli out to center. He's one of the three goal scorers here of the period. Chipped into the left wing corner. Bersani after it. Trying to play it in front. Down for the left point. Andreoli carrying along the wall all the way in behind the net. Out the far side. Centering attempt. Petrantonio couldn't get it. Cleared out to center by the Bobcats. Bersani quickly trying to step back in. Looking to feed it ahead. Hit a shin pad. Ricochets back to Bockwell at center. He'll flip it in. Liskowitz had to make a save on a bouncing puck. Now it's pitchforked out and back to the Columbus line. Bockwell moving it ahead. Andreoli tips it on. Petrantonio knocked down. Here's Andreoli in. Mini break. Forehand and could not tuck it. Past the left pad of Liskowitz. Great stop by the Blue Ridge netminder. Andreoli had a mini breakaway from the hash marks in. Puck wasn't quite settled for him, but boy, he still got a pretty good attempt off, but Liskowitz just took away the entire ice level, and that was really all Andreoli could do. So a big stop to keep it 3-0 here with 16.2 seconds to go in the second period. Draw to the left of the Bobcats net. McDonald in for the faceoff. Tied up by Blue Ridge. They swing it around. Stepping down to the left point, trying to keep it in, but cannot there as Bockwell is tip past him to center. Underwood moves over to try to help him out. Smirnoff looking to move it up. McDonald turning it the other way. Time running out here on the River Dragons as Hunter won't be able to do anything with that one. But a little bit different story here in our middle 20. We came in without a goal. We leave with a 3-0 Columbus River Dragons lead up on the scoreboard. And I will say this for Blue Ridge and any Blue Ridge fans who might be checking us out here. I'll tell you what, it's not lost for this team by any means. And I think they were able to finally staunch the bleeding when they needed to. Columbus did strike for three. Yeah, that's tough, especially against a team like Columbus that can get very stingy defensively. But there was a chance where things might have gotten a little out of hand. And certainly the power play chance of the Bobcats did help stem the tide. But right now, the Bobcats kind of got back on their game there after that little stretch that was not quite 5 minutes where Columbus scored its three goals. But the Bobcats are kind of back on their balance now, and they're going to have to figure out a way to beat Brendan Colgan, who has not been severely tested in this one. If anything, what's really been challenging has been when there's traffic in front of the net. And honestly, that's going to be the Blue Ridge recipe for success here if they're going to get anything accomplished in period number three is pucks to the net with traffic. You got to take away the eyes of the goaltender. They just haven't done that much, if at all, in this game here. And that's been the difference. Columbus capitalizes on a couple opportunities, and now 40 minutes in, they lead it 3-0. So we'll take a break here out of our wow second period into our shredaway second period intermission report. When we come back, we'll have a look back at the scoring for you. We'll wrap that up, plus a look inside the numbers from the period. As always, we've got a chance to check out that Zelmo Zippin' out-of-town scoreboard as well. Stay tuned. Plenty more coming your way. River Dragons 3, Bobcats nothing on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Let Shredaway, a division of the Overbeat Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overbeat Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the Optical Shop in Phoenix City, wants to be your local eye doctor. Specializing in diabetic eye exams, glaucoma treatment, and cataract evaluations, Phoenix Eye Clinic has an ophthalmologist on staff. They also handle all of your needs for eye exams, glasses, and contacts. Call the Phoenix Eye Clinic at 334-480-4015. That's 334-480-4015. Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the optical shop.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam. Bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Get ready to hoop it up this season in Trojan Arena with Troy Basketball. Combined season tickets for men's and women's basketball start at $75 for all 24 home games. You won't find a better deal than that. Get your Troy Basketball season tickets now at TroyTrojans.com/tickets. The action begins November 6th, and we want to see you all season long. Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy Basketball season tickets now.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-thru and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
And welcome back in the second period intermission report brought to you by Shredaway. Tom Callahan here with you, and it's a little bit different looking hockey game after two than it was after one. Columbus has taken a 3-0 lead. Three goals to tell you about in period number two, and they all came in a little stretch. Well, not a little stretch, but not quite a 5-minute gap in time. 4 minutes, 32 seconds apart. The River Dragons started the scoring 9:37. Austin Doe, his ninth from Justin McDonald and Ryan Hunter. And this goal is special because by picking up the assist there, McDonald ends up with his 300th FPHL point. So congratulations to J-Mac. That is a big milestone, and pleased that he was able to reach that in a River Dragons uniform. So that makes it 1-0. Then it's 12-16. Storjahan finishes off an Austin Doe breakaway. It was a 2-on-0 that Doe decided he was just going to take it to the net himself, and he was a little ahead of Storjahan, so understandable. He goes in, tries to do a little leave behind, tuck it between the legs on the goaltender, Liskiewicz. Liskiewicz makes the first save. The puck goes down his right pad, but he's unable to find it in time. And Storjahan, now trailing the play, goes right to the net, finds it, and tucks it past for his eighth of the year at 12-16. So now 2-0 Columbus. Then at 14:05, Justin McDonald once again plays the setup man. And this time it's for Carson Andreoli. Andreoli ends up with a puck in the slot. And Liskiewicz gambled with a poke check here. Andreoli had the puck in his skates. He was trying to collect it as he was kind of alone in the slot, cutting left to right, but you're taking a guess here. Am I going to be able to either disrupt the skates of Andreoli or knock that puck away as he tries to collect it? Well, Liskiewicz comes up empty on the poke check. Andreoli kicks the puck up to his stick, and now that Liskiewicz is down prone on the ice, all he has to do is tuck it in behind the sprawling goaltender for his second of the season at 14:05, and that caps the scoring in the period. So a little gamble, but a loss there for Liskiewicz and the Blue Ridge Bobcats, and it's 3-0 at that point. So now Doe has a goal and an assist. McDonald has two assists on the night as well. And good to see Andreoli back on the score sheet for the first time since early October for this River Dragons hockey team. Only one power play to tell you about in the period. Bersani went to the box for boarding, but the River Dragons killed it off, and so the Bobcats 0-for-1 in the power play. Still no power plays in the game for the Columbus River Dragons. They have that 3-0 lead after two periods of play. Shots in the period, 12 for Columbus, 10 for the Bobcats. Two period totals, 27 for Columbus, 17 for Blue Ridge. We'll take a break. When we come back, we've got more coming your way in just a moment. It'll be time for a look at that Zelmo Zippin out-of-town scoreboard. Plenty going on in and around the world of not only hockey, but also we'll talk to you about what's going on in the NFL tomorrow. A couple of college basketball games going on tonight. And World Junior Championships are today. If you don't know what happened, stay tuned. We'll tell you about that as well. 40 minutes in the books. This is the Shredaway second period intermission report. Columbus with a 3-0 lead over Blue Ridge. This is River Dragons Hockey. Columbus River Dragons hockey. Tom Callahan here with you as we are through 40 minutes of play in the Shredaway second period intermission report. I want to remind you the next Eve of the River Dragons event at Chick-fil-A Midland will be January 25th from 6 to 7 p.m. Come eat with the team, get autographs, pictures, and more. That's only at Chick-fil-A Midland, January 25th from 6 to 7. Speaking of Chick-fil-A Midland and our sister station, Kissin 99.3, the family four packs are on sale now for the rest of the season. And that includes four tickets to a River Dragons home game, four hot dogs, four popcorn, four Pepsi products, and four coupons for free Chick-fil-A sandwiches over a $100 value for just $40. Take advantage of this great deal brought to you by Chick-fil-A Midland, Kissin 99.3, Buffalo Rock Pepsi, Brewster's Ice Cream, and the Columbus Civic Center. Our next family four-pack date is next weekend, January 13th, against the Elmira River Sharks. The other remaining family four-pack dates, February 10th, which is Youth Hockey Night, March 16th, Faith and Family Night, and April 13th, Fan Appreciation Night. Now, these family four-packs are only available through the River Dragons office. Call 706-507-4625. That's 706-507-4625 to order yours today. Or you can always stop by during regular business hours. You can find us on the west side of the Columbus Civic Center between the main building and the practice ice rink. And come on in the courtyard. We are there 9 to 5 Monday through Friday. All right, so that's the family four packs. That's next weekend. This weekend, we've got the River Dragons and the Bobcats. Two periods in the books here. Columbus has a 3-0 lead on Blue Ridge. By the way, tomorrow night, I don't know if I've mentioned this yet, tomorrow night is the debut of the blackout jerseys for the River Dragons in 2024. So if you want to check those out, tomorrow night's a good night to do that. 7:05 puck drop, 6:30 on the pregame show. Why don't you listen to us on the way in on our flagship station, 106.9 Really Rocks. On your drive down here, I'll take you through the pregame, get you ready to go, fire you up, and then we'll turn you loose as you cheer the River Dragons on to a win over the Bobcats tomorrow night. Time for the out-of-town scoreboard, and that is brought to you by Zelmo's Zip-In. Four other games in the FPHL tonight. And the Danbury Hat-Tricks have scooted out in front of the Elmira River Sharks at First Arena. It's now 5-1. Hat-Tricks in the lead. Watertown and Motor City are tied at 2 now after two periods of play in that game. And then, man, how about the Port Huron Prowlers? Still up 1-0 on the Carolina Thunderbirds, and that one is almost to the second intermission. Nice job by Port Huron in that game. Then at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, halfway through the second period, the Baton Rouge Attico still with a 1-0 lead over the Mississippi Seawolves. In the NHL, a couple of games in the third period right now. Blackhawks and Devils are tied at 2. Dickinson and Tkachuk for Chicago. And then you have Holtz and Nemec for the Devils. Hurricanes and Capitals also tied at 2. Dowd and Strome for the Caps in that one. Burns and then Jarvis with his 14th to knot it for the Hurricanes. 10 o'clock Eastern, you've got the Jets coming up at the Ducks. College basketball, number 4, UConn survives Butler earlier, 88-81. Right now, with about 5 minutes to go in the first half, Purdue. Number 1, Purdue leading number 9, Illinois, 30-24 in that one. NFL full slate of games this weekend as the regular season comes to a close. And playoff implications abound as the Steelers are at the Ravens. That's tomorrow at 4:30. Tomorrow at 8:15, Texans are at the Colts. A couple of 9-7 teams, and there's so many scenarios for teams either making or not making the playoffs tomorrow and Sunday. It's pretty incredible. In the 1 o'clock window on Sunday, you've got Browns, Bengals, Vikings, Lions, Jaguars at Titans, Jets at Patriots, Falcons at Saints, Buccaneers at Panthers. In the 4 o'clock window, Bears at Packers, Broncos at Raiders, Eagles at Giants, Seahawks are at the Cardinals, Chiefs at Chargers, Rams at 49ers, and the Cowboys are at the Commanders. And then the Sunday night game, which will be the final regular season game, no Monday Night Football this week, the Bills are at the Dolphins. And the World Junior Championships, an incredible comeback in the bronze medal game by Czechia as they rally to stun Finland 8-5 along the way, scoring the fastest 4 goals in World Juniors history. An incredible comeback by the Czechs. So that one definitely worth checking out on the highlight reel. And then the United States. It was close with Sweden through two periods. The favorite pre-tournament, the U.S. against the host Sweden for the gold medal. 3-2 after two. Well, the United States broke it open in the third with 3 more goals for a 6-2 final. And Team USA claims gold at the World Junior Championships. So that's it for that Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard. As we have the Zamboni out there, we've chucked our pucks. And now we look forward to the River Dragons taking the ice against the Bobcats here in period number 3, trying to secure the win. It's 3-0 right now in favor of the River Dragons. They're out shooting the Bobcats 27-17. And if you're Blue Ridge, you're not feeling great about being down, by that 3-0 count, but also you've played a pretty good road game to this point. Columbus is a very explosive offensive team, and to me what matters now for that Bobcats team in the locker room right now, they have to gather themselves and they have to say, you know what, we need to come out, we need to play another excellent, boring road period, but now we need to capitalize on the mistakes that we get. They really haven't done much of that. They haven't found the net with their shots, even when they've had the opportunities. Brennan Colgan has not been tested severely. For the River Dragons, flip side of that coin, well, continue to push. Make Blue Ridge have to make quick decisions. Make Blue Ridge have to hurry those shots. Make Blue Ridge have to do things that they don't want to do. Make them uncomfortable. And I'm sure the hitting will pick up here in the third period because both of these teams are trying to prove something in this final 20. Columbus is trying to prove it can close out the Bobcats. The Bobcats are trying to prove that they've still got some life in them. So it should be a pretty interesting third period coming up next. All right, that's it for the Shredaway second period intermission report. We'll be back with more in just a moment. Third period action on the other side of the break. 3-0 Columbus after two. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We are proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon, fiberglass, and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
You know that sound anywhere. It's the crisp crunch of that first nacho chip. With its perfect cheese to sour cream ratio sitting atop a layer of delicious beans, it's a sip away from perfection. That's what we're looking for. Add a delicious, refreshing Pepsi and we've achieved absolute nacho nirvana. Because while you can pile those nachos high with every spicy, cheesy, savory topping, there's no topping a cool Pepsi finish. Nachos, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner, cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside, technology with a human touch.
And we are back at the Columbus Civic Center. Tom Callahan here with you. The officials have taken back to the ice. The teams gathering at their respective doors, getting ready to retake the surface here in just a moment. And Brendan Colgan will lead the River Dragons out. And now the Blue Ridge Bobcats back out there as well. Third period action coming up here. Teams will start it off. 5-on-5 hockey. We've actually only had one power play in this entire game. Blue Ridge 0 for 1 in the power play. Columbus has not had its opportunity yet. River Dragons are going to roll left to right in front of our broadcast location here for period number 3, which is brought to you by, as it is all season long, Kinetic Credit Union. Another terrific sponsor here on Columbus River Dragons hockey. Colgan stretching it out in the net down to our left. Colgan tonight, 9 out of 10, means we see Taylor Joseph tomorrow night. Faceoff will be coming up here on the dot at center. McDonald is out there with Doe and Hunter. So that line switch has been made to hold here into the third. Doe and McDonald combined for the start of the scoring in the second period. They start by dumping it in, but the Bobcats quickly the other way. Left siders Wolf in with a wrist shot, missed the net. Boy, what do we talk about in that second period intermission? Blue Ridge not hitting the net, and they start by once again not hitting the net. Columbus able to dig that puck out, flip it ahead into space. Hunter trying to catch up with a Basie after it. Backhanded around on the wall. McDonald to the far side, Doe stretching, and it's cleared out past Lehetka and in over the liners. Wolf left side, and he slides it in front of shot. Save Colgan, rebound into the corner. Wrap around to the far side, puck rolls away, fed to the right point, kept in, Rister in on goal, blocker save, rebound, and unable to get his chance towards the net. There was Martin. It's Columbus doing a nice job defensively, kind of collapsing down low, taking away those lanes in front of their goaltender. Doe will poke it down the length of the ice. No icing. Columbus goes to the change, 1:05 into the third. 3-0 River Dragons. Nicoletti at center. Unable to do anything with it as he runs into some traffic. Backhanded in by Columbus. Lindberg tries back up the near wall. Played along the hall. His pass ahead into space. Jelenski's moving in with a wrist shot. He scores! Rickard Jelenski's gets the Bobcats on the board. 1:26 into period number 3. And the former River Dragon scores here against his old team. And gives his new team a bit of life. So for Jelenski's, that's his first goal of the season. 1:26 in. That may have deflected off the shaft of the stick of Gill. Hard to tell, but looks like it might have changed direction on the way in. And now Blue Ridge stepping back in again, but Hall had it taken away. And a diving poke check there from Shinkarik. Boy, Blue Ridge might be feeling a little energy right now. Columbus trying to move it the other way here. Andreoli had it picked away at center. Ends up back with Shinkarik in the Columbus end. He'll backhand it off the glass and out. Turn right back in, though, Graham Mentis. Nope, hand pass. So 1:58 into the third. We get a whistle and a faceoff on the dot near center. Bersani in for the faceoff against Daly. Andreoli pushing it up the left side. He'll try to drive into the Bobcat zone, but Blue Ridge back after it. Played around the near wall and out to center it goes. Underwood at center on the backhand, flips it ahead. Columbus is going to go for the change here. Blue Ridge the other way. Here's Delcarte at center, wraps it around the rim. Colgan can't slow it down behind the net. Right side corner, pitched in behind. It bounces past Daly. Ends up in the near corner. Bounced ahead, Andreoli chips it. Here's McDonald. He's loose on the right side and over the line with a shot and just missed on the stick side. Liskowitz may have gotten a piece. Now turning the other way, Grant Mentis up one-on-one against Lahetka. Forces him wide, still gets a shot away but missed the net. Left wing cutting down the wall. Martin feeding it into the slot. Wolf jammed it towards the net. Martin in front. Puck turned over. Pop off on it. He'll get it across to Andreoli. He'll chip it out of the zone. Turned right back. Puck deflected. Right wing, and now a chance in for the Bobcats. Colgan forced to make a left pad save on that wrister from the right wing. Martin trying to keep it in. McDonald wanted to send it back deep. Smirnoff on him. Another attempt to clear. Ends up back with the D. Pop off on the right side. He'll get it back from Slahetka. Moves it up to McDonald in over the line. The pop off with a big hit. Smirnoff came to hit him, and he turned it the other way on him. Now Colgan's got to play a long lead pass intended for Smirnoff on a breakaway. Smirnoff tried to go after Popov, and Popov just dropped him, and now Basie was trying to get a fight going on his way to the bench. I didn't see who that was with. The puck rolls back out to center. Yeah, it's getting a little chippy out there, but right now Blue Ridge, the only goal of the period, it's 3-1 River Dragons. The Bobcats have life. Right side, here's Wickline carrying it ahead. A little flip into space here. Chipped into the right side corner. Jemayev tried to center. Wickline over to help mount on the right wing wall. Wickline towards the point. Shinkarik can't hold it in. Has to carry it back. Gilda Shinkarik. Shinkarik up the right side. Wickline at center. Pressured there. Lost it to Frazee, but then moved it ahead. Shinkarik. His pass is tipped down. No icing. Bobcats on the regroup here. Also getting a change. Dump it in from center, and it ends up, well, I believe that hit the linesman, and he's down. Looks like he's all right. A little slow to get up, but that's why we had the whistle there. A bit of a rough ride. Linesman indicating his back. Might be a bit of a trouble spot there, but I think he's going to be all right. I'll tell you what, you think hockey players are tough. Referees and linesmen get smoked with pucks, they get checked, and they are wearing almost no equipment. Those guys have it tough. And, well, they're checking on each other, but everything's all right. Puck is sent back. Bobcats on it, right side. They will dump it in. Colgan will steer it away to the corner. Gill over after it into the far side. Turn to center. Daly trying to walk it down the wall. Not out. Shot coming in. Punched away by the blocker of Colgan over to the near side. And now here's Bersani up on the right wing. He'll dump it in. Glove down there. Cleared back out. As Delcarte, second effort, does get it out. Columbus regrouping, stretch pass to Petrantonio Tippett. He did hit the linesman. Delcarte, though, able to move back to center. Daly challenged by Bersani, and now Petrantonio in a little comeuppance at center there. Basie comes over to shoulder with Petrantonio. There's a puck dump back in. Delcarte moving it ahead. Wolf at center. And it poked away. Wolf got it back. Right side walks in with a shot. Colgan the save. Good stop right there. And right back come the River Dragons ahead. McDonald trying to feed it in the slot. That one's deflected away. Wolf gets it out to center. Here's Martin up the left side. Bobcats in. Smirnoff leaving to Martin. His wrist shot. That's absorbed by Colgan. He'll hold out. Oh, here we go. Pushing and shoving as one of the Blue Ridge players, oh, that's Wolf, went to the front of the net, had his helmet yanked off. It's getting a little feisty here in this third period. 6-12 gone, 3-1 River Dragons in the lead. We'll take a break and come back with more in a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
You know John Deere means quality and reliability.
I'm always on the go, but with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me.
the Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app, energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability, so for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services, because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business.
I'm all
for Dragons with a 3-1 lead. 6 minutes, 12 seconds into the third period. Kinetic Credit Union, the sponsor of our third period. How about Ricard Jelenski's? Scoring the goal that gets Blue Ridge on the board against his former team. And they have awarded the assist on that goal to Lindberg and Hall. And it's gotten a little chippier here in period number three. Fanksov will be to the right of Colgan. Yes, looks like that's the circle they will gather. We didn't have any penalties handed out, and again, it's been pretty much a penalty-free contest for the most part. We've had only one power play. That belonged to the Bobcats, and they were 0-for-1 with that power play. Faceoff coming up to the right of Colgan. Wolf jumped early on the faceoff. Puck was never down. So Martin and McDonald will stage once again. Finally, it's dropped. River Dragons control it. They clear off the glass to the line. Oaks keeping it in, only momentarily poked out by Doe. Left side, here's Hunter. Cutting in on the wall. Hunter with an off-angle chance. Lisko hits the save. Bobcats the other way, looking for the breakaway stretch, and they find it. Here's a chance, and Smirnoff scores. He goes backhand, forehand, and tucks it past Colgan. And the Bobcats, with a pair of goals to start this third period, are now within one. It's 3-2. For Sava Smirnov, that's his fourth goal of the year. Couldn't come at a better time. And I'll tell you what, this Bobcats team is believing on that bench that they can bring it back closer. Maybe even tie it up here. It's 3-2 now. And Columbus has had a bit of a flat response to start this third.
Blue Ridge goal number 15, Sava Smirnov.
Martin and Wolf the assists. Well, Columbus is going to have to put it back into gear in a hurry here. As they move in on the offensive side, here's Storjahan. Trying to feed it up top. Right point, Shinkarik lost it at the line. Sends it back in, but Columbus has to tag it up. Lead on the wing. Hall on the left side. And over the Columbus line, but the wrist shot missed the net. Around it goes and back out to center. Frazee cutting to the right side. Trying to work his way in, poked off his stick. He'll feed to the right point. Wrist shot is deflected away by Jemayev. And oh boy, looks like he hurt his hand on that one, but he's all right, I think. Left side, Jelenski's in the corner. Centering attempt there, poked away. Columbus still can't clear. Now they finally get it out. Wick line to center. And with the River Dragons struggling a little bit here. Gill. Pressured, has to dump it off the glass away to center. And now back in Vlasov, his shot tipped to the far corner. Grant Mentis centers off the skate of Gill into the near corner. Petrantonio Tips it up the wall, and now Bersani moves up with Andreoli. Hunter Bersani right side with a long shot in. Blocker save. Andreoli after the rebound goes all the way up to the left point, and that puck is tipped out by the Bobcats. Vlasov quickly getting it across, but Grant Mentis overskated. Bockwell the other way, and now Bersani trying to break in behind the D. Had a stick held. Gets away left side, though. Looking at Brett Bersani. His attempt is tipped into the netting. I wonder if we might not see a few more power plays coming up here now, as the clutching and grabbing that was not being called for the first 2.5 periods of this game, you kind of wonder if it might come to bear here. 8:18 into this third period, 3-2 Columbus in the lead. Faceoff to the right of the Bobcats' goal. McDonald in for the faceoff. And it went back towards the left point. Underwood steps down the wall, try to get it into the corner. Basie plays it around the rim. On to the right side, Bockwell holding it in. Doe, far side, trying to spin away from the check of Basie. He's got him wrapped up. He gets it in front of backhand try, and that's set up over top of the net by McDonald. Ends up in the netting. The deflection will keep the faceoff inside the zone. Bobcats have also caught up in the shots on goal parade here. It was 27-17 entering the period. It's now 29-26. Columbus only two shots here in the first 8.5 of this period. Hunter on the right side. McDonald to the right point. Underwood try to feed it back down low, but that's cut off and cleared out off the skate of McDonald. River Dragons step back in as Doe dumps it in on goal. Liskowitz will play it aside. Bobcats looking to regroup here, feeling much more confident in this third period. They've scored twice. They're looking for the equalizer. Here's Wolf cutting into the high slot, but he gave it up. River Dragons try to push back through center as it's popped up in the air over the head of Hunter. Wolf back, feeding Martin. Martin into the slot. He's bodied off the puck by Bockwell. Now goes back and gets it again, but he fed it to the point. Nobody there. Lindbergh after it. He'll lead it ahead. Underwood back on it. Left side. Try to poke it ahead. Storjahan on the wing. He'll dump it in on goal. Liskowitz will leave it aside. And again, Blue Ridge quickly up through the ice with that pass for Hall. Got away from him, but he steals it back. Left side, here's Hall. Moving into the Columbus end. Centering attempts. Lehecka blocked it. We approach the halfway mark of period number three. Columbus up 3-2. Bobcats have made it a game here in the third. Nicoletti at center with it. Pass to Jelenski. He lost it off the Dasher wick line. Tried to turn it ahead. Bouncer does get in over the line. Now left side, here's Jemayev looking in front. Can't get the pass through. Jemayev around the rim to the left point. Lehecka over to the right side. Pop off. Takes off the Dasher. Doesn't shoot. Carries to the right corner. Centering feed through the skates of wick line. Left point. Lehecka drive. Missed the net. Arana comes to the right point. Storjan holding it in. Tied up to the far side, Jemayev trying to get over there. Blue Ridge on it. They will clear and put it out of play. Is that delay game? No, it was tipped. All right, 9:31 to go here in this third period. We'll come back with more in just a moment. 3-2 Columbus leads. This is River Draft.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
I'm thirsty.
Try this.
Starry.
It's a new lemon lime soda that's crisp, clear, and
so refreshing. So tasty.
What the?
Shh. Just let it happen.
No!
Oh, chill.
It was a soda.
New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. It's different.
And we are back. 9:31 to go in period number three. River Dragons 3, Bobcats 2. Tom Callahan here with you. And this one is coming down towards the wire. Right now for the River Dragons, they've given up a couple here in this period. I think they'd like to restore a bit of a cushion, but meanwhile, the Bobcats are just one goal away from getting right back in on top of it. The question is, can they do it? Face-off in the Blue Ridge end. Petrantonio on it. Feeds it behind the net to Bersani. Bersani centers right through the crease, but Andreoli was tied up, couldn't get a stick to it. Still not out of the zone. Now Blue Ridge able to feed it out to center. And back comes Andreoli. Right side, in with a shot that is sticked on a play by Liskowitz. Faceoff will come to the left of the Bobcats net. Here's McDonald in for the faceoff. Try to pull it back. Ends up with Basie. Basie off the glass. Gets it out to center. Shinkarik trying to pick it up. Instead pushing it is Wolf. And Shinkarik now wins the battle and clears it out. If you're just joining us, the story of the game has been one power play, and that belonged to the Bobcats. They're 0 for 1. But beyond that, it was 3-0 River Dragons in the second. Blue Ridge has come out and executed the game plan here in the third, but now a chance over the left side. Here's a race. Here's Hunter trying to beat Basie back. He has a rolling puck with a shot. Liskowitz out to make the save, and he'll hang on. Basie gives Hunter a little extra chomp in the shins there as they separate, but unfortunately for Ryan Hunter, that puck never settled for him. He was trying to get it to settle down, just could not. Faceoff will be to the right, the Bobcats' goal. Andreoli in the corner, now Bersani knocked down right off the faceoff with a high stick. I don't know if that's going to be a two or a four as they come over to look at him. See what the indication is here. Yeah, right off the faceoff, though. I think it's only going to be two. Indeed, it is only two. But the first power play of the game for Columbus as they go on to the Loft power play, where they are third in the league this year, 25.3%. Ninth on the kill, 76% for Blue Ridge. And boy, this is a critical power play. DeFrazy into the box. River Dragons go to work setting it up. They win the draw. Storjahan on the right side. Up to the right point, Doe. Right side, Storjahan. Down low to the near circle. McDonald trying to center, knocked away. Then moving up top to Dole. Dole, McDonald, his shot blocked in front. Clearing attempt, not out. Dole over to the far end up. Petrantonio doesn't shoot. Up top to Dole. Dole to McDonald. To Dole. McDonald, his shot tipped to the glass. Puck is underneath one of the Blue Ridge defenders who tries to eat it. It's picked out. River Dragons control, and now there's a wrestling match at the side of the net between Storjahan and one of the Blue Ridge players as they end up down on the ice together. Storjahan was upset because the Blue Ridge player was diving on the puck, and that's Wolf. I'll tell you what, Wolf's been fired up tonight. Well, they're both going to end up in the box. So it's 4-on-3 power play now for a minute 14 seconds. The Loft features live music every Friday and Saturday night, and tomorrow night it is a River Dragons post-game party at the Loft, so join us. Looks like they're both going to get perhaps roughing minors here. Indeed, that is the case. Well, they're going to call it coincidentals and leave it 5-on-4 power play time. So the River Dragons have to modify the power play unit just a little bit here. So it's Lahetka at the left point, along with Wickline, Hunter, Jemayev, and Shinkarik, who is playing up on the left wing here on this point. Of course, Shinkarik, a defenseman. Face-off to the right of the Bobcats goal. Slahatka at the left point. He'll carry it down to the left side corner, trying to center. Wickline after it. Wickline in the left wing. He'll feed it up top. River Dragons trying to go to work. Here's Jemayev. Back across. Shinkarik, Slahatka, middle of the blue line. Jemayev, top of the near circle. It is 5-on-4. Here's Hunter. Moving up top himself, feeds it side of the net. Jemayev right through the slot, turned over and cleared down the ice. Wickline was moving, and the pass never found him. 40 seconds to go on the power play. 3-2 Columbus. Well, this power play has a lot of weight to it right now. And it's turned over at center. Here's Daly moving it up the left side. Smirnoff in over the line. Wickline taking it off on the wall, and now to center Nicoletti. Stumbles, lost it to Jemayev. Jemayev cutting in the left side. He'll curl, wait for help. Move it into the left side corner. There's Jemayev. A one-time shot. Save made. Rebound to the glass. Clear to the left point and held in. Slahatka. Back across the blue line. Looking for a seam. Lets it go. Missed on the stick side. Jemayev chasing it over to the wall. And the power play expires. River Dragons 0-for-1 on the loft power play. Hunter. Try to squeeze back in on the right wing side. Cutting it on goal with a shot, save made. Rebound cleared out. And again, now it's 3-2. 6:09 and counting to go in this third period. River Dragons in the lead. Bobcats have made it interesting. Bounce back down the ice. Bockwell after it. Around the rim it goes. Columbus up the left side. Bersani. Bersani in over the line. In with a wrist shot. Save made. Liskowitz. Rebound away to the right side. Underwood. On the wall. Feeding it around. Grant Mentis on it over there. Bothered by Bersani. Turned over to Andreoli in the left side corner. Andreoli tried to walk it in front. Poked away. Andreoli and Basie still wrapped up as Blue Ridge trying to get the puck out of the zone. And they're still wrestling on the back of the net. Play blown dead, and you know what? Basie cost his team an offensive chance there because Blue Ridge had it in the O zone. We're trying to get something going, and instead, Basie wrestles Andreoli down on top of the net. Looks like they're going to take them both, but now that kind of hurts. It also hurts the River Dragons by taking Andreoli in that trade. .14:44, time of the penalties. I can appreciate a little Hold Me Now by the Thompson Twins after that hug fest behind the net. Face off back down to the right of Colgan. 4-on-4, so some extra ice out there. Well, they both get unsportsmanlike. Shot in on Colgan off the draw, is handled and held. Little pile in front of the net. Doesn't amount to much. Face-off again to the right of Colgan coming up. 5:11 to go into third. River Dragons up 3-2 on the Bobcats. Puck is won back to the left point. Delcart in with a shot. Save made. Colgan rebound to the near side wall. Bockwell on it. He'll move that head towards Petrantonio. Clears it off the glass away to center. Doe chasing it down. Under 5 to go into third. And now as time ticks down on Blue Ridge. Let's see how they pressure to try to find the equalizer. River Dragons turn it over. Kept in left side. Here's Petrantonio. All the way up to the blue line. Hooks it back across. Fed to the right wing looking for Underwood. That one is taken away. And now back the other way. Ivanov. Nope, he'll loop back in. His mates are changing. He'll let them finish. McDonald out with Sorjahan now. And now sweeping by and moving it up through center. Smirnoff to the right side, in with a wrist shot, deflected wide. McDonald will get it around to the far wall. Columbus now to attack. Here's McDonald. Shinkarik gives it to him on the right side, heads to the net. Now behind the play, Sorjahan in with a shot, and that one is shouldered away by Leskowitz. Gill keeps it in at the right point. Tried to send it deeper. Martin knocked it down. He's able to skate it to center. Martin ahead, in over the line. Martin cutting to his right, backs up, wrist shot, missed the goal. 28 seconds to go on the 4-on-4. McDonald on it, don't fling it around the far side. Sorjahan waiting for it. He'll get it ahead. Gill is up by himself. He's up 1-on-2. Ryan Gill will just stop at the corner, try to eat the puck down there for a minute. He's at the end of his shift. Grant Mentis picks it away, moves it to center. Here's Daly cutting on the right side, moving in over the line. That one taken away by a combination of Petrantonio and Shinkarik. Back to 5-on-5 hockey we go. 3:11 to go into third. 3-2 your score. Gill behind the net. Plays it on the near side. Delcart steps down for the point to keep it going. Grant Mentis, centering feed, chipped out by the River Dragons. Petrantonio racing to catch it the other way. Cannot. Puck outside the line. Bersani had to peel back out to keep it onside. Andreoli had to tag up. That allows Ivanov to take it away, but now it's stolen back by Bersani. Bersani tried to one-hand it in front. It was blocked. Delcart clearing it towards the line. Vlasov gets to center. Wickline cuts back in as Andreoli with him. Wickline in with a shot, and he missed on the stick side. Bersani feeding it down low. Picked up by Daly. Wickline knocks Daly off the puck. Helped around the wall, however. Bobcats to center. And that lead pass missed. Will it be icing? Yes. 2:21 to go in the third period. We'll take a quick break. 10 seconds along the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2 Fort Moore, Columbus. And W295 AY Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
And now to our final media timeout of the period.
We all dream. But dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
I'm always on the go, but with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app, energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
2:21 to go into third. River Dragons 3, Bobcats 2. Tom Callahan here with you. And in this Kinetic Credit Union third period, 5-on-5, and we're going to keep an eye on the Bobcats' net to see if Liskowitz starts to creep towards the net anytime, or towards the bench, pardon me, anytime soon. Don't forget our Pepsi postgame show coming up following tonight's game, including our Wade Cleaners three stars of the game. And a look back at that Zelmo zipping out of town scoreboard. And they're going to have the clock operator hold the clock for 2 seconds here. So there's actually 2:21 left to go here in this third period. 3-2 Columbus. Bersani in for the faceoff. He's out with Jemea from Wickline. They tie up in the circle over it. Still tied up, finally pulled back by the Bobcats as they bank it out. Popoff tried to glove it, couldn't come up with it. Left sider's Grant Mentis moving in, cutting to the slot. Grant Mentis to his right with a shot save. Colgan, big rebound taken away. And Jemea trying to clear, gets it towards Bersani. A pinball's back to the D. And it's Lahetka will just dump it out. Bobcats back the other way. Here's Grant Mentis on the right side again, trying to slide it in front. And that's taken away by Jemea in traffic. Jemea will send it down the ice. Bersani up after it, no icing. Bersani knocks his man down in the corner. Puck is underneath Bersani. He's not moving. Now he plays it along. Scoots it over towards Doe. Doe feeds it up top. Underwood fakes. Gets it over Petrantonio. Lets it go through a screen. Save made Liskowitz. Minute and a half to go into third. Blue Ridge is trying to get their goaltender out of there, and they can't right now. They'll move it ahead. Liskowitz looking at the bench. Doesn't get the signal yet. Now the puck dumped in, but turned back out by the River Dragons. And now a race up the right side. Here's McDonald. McDonald into the right wing corner. McDonald centers. Nobody there for it. Left point. Bockwell down. He'll keep it deep. 1 minute to go in the third. Well, the River Dragons doing a nice job of containing the puck right now at the right point. Here's Underwood, and he takes a big hit. Puck out of the zone now up the left side. Here's Hall. Hall moving in as an angle feeds it across. Ends up on the wing to Yelensky's. The goaltender is finally out. River Dragons on it. They have a chance at the empty net at center here. It'll just be dumped off the dasher by Doe. Back the other way. Martin had it poked away by Wickline. Ends up back with the D. Left side stretch. Smirnoff will dump it in. 27 seconds to go. 6-on-5. As the extra man out for Blue Ridge. Wickline trying to clear, cannot. Puck in the far side, Underwood to the line, still not out. Underwood blocks a shot. Underwood ahead to center. Here's Jemath. He's got an open net on the left wing. In with a shot, he scores. Alexander Jemath scores the empty net goal to cement the win. 4-2 for the River Dragons with 10.7 seconds to go. Jemath even had the stick slashed out of his hands, broken in half. Didn't matter. Puck was in. .1949, time of the goal. And Jemath, the first River Dragons player to hit the 20-goal plateau this season. Faceoff tied up at center. Columbus will dump it back in, and the clock will run down. River Dragons win it. And so we'll take a quick break, move it into the Pepsi postgame show. When we come back, it's Cyber Away Cleaners, three stars of the game, including a nice level interview with tonight's first star. Back with more in a moment. River Dragons win 4-2. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Peppermint season is back at Tim Hortons with even more peppermint flavor. It's the tastiest, mintiest way to cheers the holidays. Tis the season to treat yourself with any $1 medium latte when you order on the app. Only at Tim Hortons.
Thirsty.
Try this.
Starry.
It's a new lemon lime soda that's crisp, clear, and
so refreshing. So tasty.
What the?
Shh. Just let it happen.
No!
Oh, chill.
It was a soda.
New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. It's different.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated.
It is indeed time for our Wade Cleaners, three stars of the game. Let's turn it over to PA announcer Dana Barker. Cup says your first star. Justin McDonald, his 300th and 301st FPHL points here tonight. A couple of assists in the victory for the River Dragons, 4-2 over the Blue Ridge Bobcats. We'll take a break. We'll come back with more here in just a moment. Stay tuned. It's the Pepsi postgame show on River Dragons Hockey.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled-to-perfection burger sounds amazing, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang, burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavor.
At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability. So for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place.
It's the way we do business.
Peppermint season is back at Tim Hortons with even more peppermint flavor.
It's the tastiest, mintiest way to cheers the holidays. Tis the season to treat yourself with any $1 medium latte when you order on the app. Only at Tim Hortons.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account. All from...
And we're back at the Pepsi postgame show. Tom Callahan here with you. Thank you so much for joining me, everybody. River Dragons victorious tonight, 4-2, your final score. Let's go back through the scoring in this one. Well, no scoring in the first period in this one. No penalties either. And the first 20 minutes went by fairly uneventfully. But then in the second, the River Dragons woke up offensively in a stretch just under 5.5 minutes long. Columbus scored three times. They started it off at 9:38, Austin Doe, his ninth of the year from Ryan Hunter and Justin McDonald. And with that assist, Justin McDonald hits a personal milestone, his 300th FPHL point. And that was followed quickly at 12:16 by Alex Storjahan, his eighth of the year from Doe. Doe came in on a breakaway and tried to slide the puck back between the legs of the goaltender Liskowitz. He made the initial save, but the puck was sitting on his right pad. Storjahan following up the play, able to tuck it home for the goal, and it's 2-0. And then at 14:05, just under 2 minutes later, it's Carson Andreoli, his second of the year and his first goal since back in October. Actually, game number two against Baton Rouge. McDonald, another assist on the evening, and it's 3-0. River Dragons are rolling at that point. But in the third, Blue Ridge, it's interesting. 40 minutes into it, we sat there and talked about it in that Treadaway second period intermission report. I had a checklist for both teams, River Dragons and the Blue Ridge Bobcats. Well, Blue Ridge executed their checklist. They came out. They still had hope. They really only had that bad five-minute stretch. Other than that, they kind of went back to the game plan of dull, boring road hockey. The difference was hitting the net with shots and converting on their chances. In the first minute or so of the period, they had a couple chances, but again, missed the net. However, at 1:26, they finally hit the net, and it's the former River Dragon, Rickard Zielenskis, with his first of the year from Lindbergh and Hall. And now the Bobcats are on the board, and you could feel the emotion and the energy coming from that Bobcats bench. 5 minutes later at 6:32, Smirnoff, his fourth from Martin and Wolf, and all of a sudden, it was a completely different hockey game. The Bobcats were believing that they could get back in this game. And indeed, as penalties started to pile up a little bit, although we had a couple spurts of coincidentals here, it really did stay close until the very end. Alexander Chimaev pots his 20th into an empty net, 19:49, time of the goal from Underwood and Wickline. But credit to the Bobcats. That's a much improved hockey team, even from the last time we saw them. And they have some jam now, but they also have some belief in themselves. I don't know that Blue Ridge turns it around anywhere near in time to snag that fourth playoff spot, but I suppose you never know. Remember, top four teams in each division make it. There's six in the Continental Division, so two teams are going to be on the outside looking in. Right now, the Bobcats are dead last in the FPHL, and they don't pick up any points tonight. Stranger things have happened. And in 2024, I think that Blue Ridge is going to make a charge. I don't know if they're going to make enough of a charge to get into the playoff picture, but I think they're poised to make a charge. So definitely a team to keep an eye on. Each team finishes the night 0-for-1 on the power play. Shots by period, Columbus 15 in the first, 12 in the second, 10 in the third for 37. Blue Ridge 7, 10, and 11 for 28. Let's take one more break here in this Pepsi postgame show. When we come back, we're going to wrap it up with a final look back at the Selmo's zipping out of town scoreboard. A couple of finals coming in from around the league. We'll tell you about those and more. Stay tuned. River Dragons win it here 4-2 tonight. We're back to wrap it up. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Dragons Hockey.
You got your tribal. that you're in luck. Pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck. Pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
Introducing New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. Music to my ears.
You don't have ears.
Starry, it's different.
Welcome back here in the Pepsi Postgame Show. Tom Callahan here with you as we wrap things up here from our broadcast location high atop the Columbus Civic Center. 4-2 River Dragons with the win here tonight. Time to take a look back at the Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard. Zelmo Zip-In has been fueling life's passions since 1999. Finals coming in from around the FPHL now. You have Danbury finishing off the Elmira River Sharks tonight by a 6-1 count. And then a Watertown Arena in overtime. Motor City has claimed victory 4-3 over the Watertown Wolves. Now in overtime, how about this? Port Huron was holding a 1-0 lead through most of this game, but Carolina fought back, tied it up at 1, and now the Thunderbirds have won it in overtime at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. And then at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, this game about halfway through the third period between Baton Rouge and Mississippi is now tied at 3. NHL 2 finals from earlier, Devils 4-2 over the Blackhawks, Hurricanes 6-2 over the Capitals. Just underway, Jets and Ducks, no score in that one. Men's college basketball. In the second half with about 9 minutes left, number 1 Purdue 68-52 over number 9 Illinois. Number 4, UConn holds on earlier today over unranked Butler, 88-81. In the NFL, big weekend as they close out the regular season. Tomorrow at 4:30, Steelers at Ravens, 8:15, Texans at Colts. Then in the 1 o'clock window, you got Browns, Bengals, Vikings, Lions, Jags, Titans, Jets, Patriots, Falcons, Saints, Bucks, and Panthers. In the 4 o'clock window, it's Bears, Packers, Broncos, Raiders, Eagles, Giants, Seahawks, Cardinals, Chiefs at the Chargers, Rams at the 49ers, and Cowboys at the Commanders. Bills at the Dolphins, the last game of the weekend. No Monday Night Football this week, 8:20 p.m. Eastern Time, NBC, the Sunday night game of the week. And the World Junior Championships, an unlikely but thrilling comeback. Czechia with a record fastest 4 goals ever in World Juniors history comes back to beat Finland, 8-5 the final in the bronze medal game. And then in the gold medal game, the United States, the pre-tournament favorite against host Sweden. It was 3-2 USA after 2 periods of play. And in the third, the U.S. broke it open, scoring 3 more times, 6-2 your final. And the United States claims World Juniors gold. That's it for our Pepsi postgame show. As we wrap up that Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard, we're back at it tomorrow night. Same two teams, should be a good one. And it's the debut of the blackout jerseys for the Columbus River Dragons. 7:05 on the puck drop means a 6:30 pregame show time. And we hope as you're on your way in here to the Columbus Civic Center, you'll tune us in on the radio 106.9 Really Rocks. Or if you're a passenger in the car, you can certainly always watch on the YouTube side if you want. We're at Columbus River Dragons. So thank you so much to everybody, my crew here tonight, for being a part of things and getting us through here this evening. It's another tremendous win for the Columbus River Dragons, who now, with the victory and Carolina winning in overtime, Columbus at 16-3-2-0-0, 50 points. Second team in the league to the 50-point plateau, and now all alone by a point on top of the Continental Division. We'll talk to you tomorrow night, everybody. One more time, your final score, River Dragons 4, Bobcats 2.